shit don't feel as good as it look. I'ma keep it real with you. I'm straight though. Street shit made me what I am today, niggas.
Nah, I went so hard for that shit, I deserve this shit, niggas.
Ah, butcher coming, nigga. This ain't my story about rags to riches, more about how I mastered physics. In a game I used to train like Rocky, catching chickens. I was nice, but they was right when they told me that rap was business. I had 10 bands in my stash when I passed over half a million. Come easy, no good, don't be surprised I'll last these niggas. It's like they put out a smash, then they gone in a flash, admit it. And then they make tracks and disses like that's gonna add up the digits. They showing fake racks and pictures like that's gonna attract the bitches. That was really me, nigga. I ain't have to act and conflicted. Only difference is I'm living. And I would've whacked one of them niggas who knew that after drug dealing, I'd still be casual, spending mil plus annual income. So here's my manual and some. And this Eastside shit still in me. My ability to turn words to imagery. Probably the reason they gon' remember me. Figure we walk this tightrope with a feline's agility. The streets did so much shit to me, I could never live civilly. I can never leave a scene without checking my mirrors visually. Come with that energy, cause some shit gon' always stick with me. They wanna know what I brought to Griselda, I say validity. They asking what work that niggas put in, I'm like, what didn't we? Problems, then I correct through the obstacles, I progress. Illogical for them to feel they responsible for our success. Besides Kanye West, tell me who else I gotta respect. Cause I'm kinda perplexed, it's about time that I got my respect. It's the Butcher, nigga. Ah. Let's go.
About time that I got my respect, it's the Butcher, nigga. Yeah. Cold fucking world. Griselda shit, know what I mean?
Griselda.
You know what it is, nigga? When I show up, I'm on 10, nigga, not 9. On the night I was born, the rain was pouring. God was crying, lightning struck, power outage, sparks was flying. The real one's here, the young boy that walked with lions. Around the outlines of chalk where the corpse is lying. Of course I'm trying to revive a sport that's dying. But the guns and the drug bars that y'all relying. Got these nerves thinking that you niggas hard as iron. But that just mean I ain't as comfortable as y'all with lying. Stretching the truth, no I never stress in the booth. They feel the pressure, me I feel like I just left a masseuse. Effortless, how I'm skating on these records is proof. I put your favorite rapper neck in a noose, never letting them loose. Cold world, the heater blast of your speaker. He the last of Mohicans, no weaklings last in my sneakers. Nigga want me on the song, he gon' see the wrath of the reaper. I'm probably gon' go to hell if Jesus asked for a feature. I'm higher than niggas, it don't need a bag for the reefer. Some see the glass as empty, I see the ass full of ether. Collecting his bread and mass like he a Catholic preacher. Just to count a nigga cash, you might need a calculus teacher. Eureka, Einstein on the brink of the theory of relativity. Really, no MC equal. Feel me, Copen be lethal, crip like an old MTV show. On God, the best rapper alive. Headshot, not going ass. The best rappers that died, they tell you he never lied, nigga. Yeah. Tenor talk.
Hello. Let me just check my my audio levels here. I always got to tweak these. I got to get a new microphone, man. We got to step this shit up. I've been unprofessional for far too long, but we're going to change it. We're going to change it. Once I actually get some cash flow, some bread, I'm going to get a new microphone, new studio set up. You're going to see. I'll be shining. I got plans. But I figured we'd start with some Benny because we're going to be talking about a different Benny. We're going to be talking about Ben the Loony. Now, that's a name that carries a lot of weight with certain people and carries no weight with others. So I'm gonna give you a very quick rundown, first and foremost, of who this guy is. And then from there, we're gonna take a look at some of his content, some of his art, some of his beliefs. I'm very excited. Let me just get this set up. Oh, goddamn, Liquid Snappy already? With $10. I'm sure this Ben guy is a relatively sane individual. Totally sane individual. He's a great guy. He's a pretty cool dude. I just wanted to give him a bit of exposure. But Ben the Looney is a unique character. He is a big fan of cheese pizza. He makes cheese pizza. He reviews cheese pizza. He reviews regular pizza as well. But he's quite passionate about characters who are not able to give permission without a parent. I'm trying to find elaborate ways to say that he's a pedophile, but he is a pedophile. So, and he is a porn artist, and he draws god-awful porn, which I can't show a ton of, but I can show a few things, and you're not going to like any of them. All right, so let me move my dumb black ass out of the way. Let me scooch this over. Okay. All right, so I'll zoom this in a bit too, and all of us can read together, okay? So who is Ben the Looney? Ben the Looney, FKA Puffyzilla Man 4, is a former cartoon ranter and reviewer and current artist who has routinely expressed his interest in NSFW material, namely material focused on characters that are not of age. Routinely hiding behind the idea of aging characters up, Ben would often draw Ami and Yumi being railed from all directions by malformed and poorly drawn penises. He has drawn minors like Ami, Yumi, Penny Gadget, Misty, Ryuku Matoi, and many others in compromising situations, and has doubled down on the value of expression through the most creative and celebrated of the muses, poorly drawn cartoon tits. Ben briefly pivoted to story animation content, but the well dried up because the bulk of his experiences were working as a janitor and working at McDonald's. As well as a handful of college experiences. I'll just briefly interrupt that. Dr. Negus would be wildin' with the five. I'm sure this guy is hinged and makes stuff that isn't worse than Enter. Y'all have jokes, and I appreciate that from each and every one of you. moving right along. Ben, despite his lack of understanding of anatomy, proportion, lighting, color theory, and character design, graduated from art school, assumedly as an act of grace or the generous grading of a professor tired of his shit. One of Ben's most infamous moves was defending and supporting infamous porn artist and cheese pizza connoisseur Shadman, a video that he has since privated but that has been scrutinized by many, including Just Stop, a good friend of the show, right, DePreston? What I aim to do here, as in right now, is take a look at a weirdo who is predominantly into NSFW art and weird garbage and give you, the viewers, the keys to dig deeper if you're so inclined. I cannot show his porn, and none of you want to see that. And I have your best interests in mind. I really do. But let's read a few of his experiences. Here are just a few excerpts of what he tends to say on the regular about pornography. I do not appreciate your jokes. I do, in moderation. I do. I truly do. It's good to see you, Esmeralda. I saw you in Claw's stream earlier, so nice to have you pop by as per the norm. Hello, folks. You can tell by my drawings that I'm a perverted son of a gun. One of the things I'll mention about this guy is that he refuses to swear despite drawing horrific pornography. He hates swearing and cursing. So he has this, like, bizarre kind of balance of him being like extremely puritanical about like cursing and being rude, but then, you know, drawing disgusting pornography of minors. So yeah, he's an interesting fucking guy. I've always been fascinated by sex and all that juicy stuff. Don't know how I got this way. Maybe my parents sheltering me and their strong Christian household contributed to my desires. Or maybe I'm just compensating for the fact that I haven't had many attractions to women in real life. As I was waiting for the perfect one to come into my life. Oh, we got a love quester. Victor Martinez with the one, no message. Thank you very much. However, since that one didn't work, I'm back to being left only with my thoughts and my own insanity. So I've been wanting to draw the kind of stuff I really like, the stuff that gets me excited to see, the stuff I feel I was born to unleash onto the world. However, whenever I tried to, I'd either be restricted by my own shyness or personally ashamed of anything I drew that would be tame even by porn standards. I was afraid anything I drew would only be used as fuel for people to hate me. Well, it's pretty prophetic. When they don't even take the time to talk to me like a person and get to know just how laid back and kind-hearted I really am. So soon after this message, he responded with this. I'm done. I'm tired of getting accused of being a pervert slash pedophile simply because I made new drawings of cartoon characters. Cartoon characters, for crying out loud. They're not real. I'm not hurting anybody by doing it. If you don't like it, that's fine. But don't go accusing me of being a freak simply because I'm an artist. I should be able to draw whatever the hell I want. But no, not in this ultra PC society. I only made the drawings because, hey, a lot of other artists do it. What's the harm in a few drawings? Apparently, breasts are the most offensive thing on the freaking planet. There are floods going on in Louisiana, and some people are worried about me making a few suggestive drawings. What the hell? So yeah, very, very Chris-esque at times. This was part of his Q&A. Describe yourself in three words. Quiet, loving, erotic. What type of art do you tend to favorite the most? Sexual animated women fan arts. No shame! So yeah, we're in for it, guys. We're in for it. I'm very excited to dive these depraved depths with each and every one of you. We're going to take a look at a few more of his lowlights before we get into his art and into his video. So let's take a look at his feelings on Shadman. Now, for the uninitiated, Shadman was an artist who had a tendency to draw underage characters and underage actual people. But he went to prison for stabbing someone, and I believe he was a heroin addict. So yeah, pretty cool guy. For my thoughts on Shad, I'll be the first to admit that I don't like a lot of what he draws, but at the same time, I don't like censorship even more. From what I know, Shad only drew two real kids, Keem's daughter and Lieutenant Corbis. Well, he actually also drew Daphne Keene, who played X-23, and I think he's drawn several other actual kids. And then he drew a bunch of fictionalized kids, but whatever. Two's a lot worse than zero. Two's much worse than zero. You're a certified pervert if you draw one child like that. So the fact that he drew three like that, I mean, I don't have to tell you about Shadman. Pretty much everyone knows about him. No shame, library dork. No shame. The thing is, neither of those drawings were pornographic. The Lieutenant Corbis one was suggestive, but pornographic? Far from it. Oh, it's just a wholesome, suggestive illustration of a child. My bad. Okay, yeah, my bad. Yeah, Millie Bobby Brown. So that brings us to four real children drawn in sexual situations by Shadman. I don't support a lot of what Shad does, but I respect his right to do what he wants and push the boundaries a bit without getting into serious trouble. And I think people who take pride in trying to make him fail are even sicker than he is. That's just my two cents.
Well, thank you. Thank you for your insight, Benjamin the Loony. I don't know about you guys, but I've always kind of been baffled by the idea of, censorship coming into play when it's something, truly depraved. Like, this is just something despicable and that should not
should not be discussed or shown. So yeah, it kind of blows my mind that these people are so willing to overlook that to fit their stupid narrative. So here's Martin Luther King. Well, Super Heavy Weapons guy, we're looking at a animator and cartoon reviewer who is a hilariously open pedo, and he may or may not have done an interview on a notable podcast. Not mine, someone else's. But we'll get to that. So here's Martin Luther King, and we gotta read the quote that he's got on here. We'll get to it, but I needed to show you guys fucking Martin Luther King Jr. as drawn by Ben the Looney. All right. So we have a bit of a debate between a like JoJo's Bizarre Adventure artist on Twitter and our good friend Benny the Butcher. So peanut head, my head doesn't look like a peanut. So, you know, this person's saying, please fix your fucking faces, Jesus Christ. Also, freckles don't look like skin cancer. To which Benny responds with, why don't you draw something that ain't JoJo fan art for once in your life, kid? To which this artist responds, why don't you draw something that isn't a noodle-limbed, allergic reaction-faced naked girl for once in your life, sad 24-year-old? And they drew this, you know, kind of flawed, but relatively good, like, Araki-style piece there.
See, not so nice when people are rude to you, is it?
The thing is, I can tell the difference between criticism and people being salty assholes. I've been trying to draw less JoJo because I know my weaknesses, and I've taken them into account, so I can improve in my ways. Now you?
I've been doing a lot of anatomy and face practice in my sketchbook. I just don't have that kind of stuff online because I don't have a camera.
If you don't have a camera, how did you outline from pictures or sketches back in the day?
That camera broke.
Use your phone or get a new one.
Can't afford one right now. No matter. I never use it anyway.
So, you know, ultimately we got a lot of deflection. We got a lot of deflecting from Benny here, where even when this person, after kind of the shots at him, goes like, oh, hey, why don't you do this? He's very unwilling to hear the actual critiques. Yeah, Jar Jar Cookie Quest. That's right. Martin Luther King and that looks like two Maltesers fused together. Jesus Christ, you guys. So, moving right along, we have some logs of a conversation he had in the Discord regarding a Soul Bro number 3 video, where I think Soul Bro number 3 was giving advice about voice acting. And one of the things he had mentioned, and he's a voice actor and does like online parodies and dubs and stuff, was that you're going to want an XLR mic rather than a USB mic, because an XLR connection, it basically just gets sound data cleaner and clearer through an interface than you ever could through a USB. Because, you know, if you have sound through a USB, it's going to be digitized, it's going to sound tinnier, you're just always going to have a worse sound from a USB mic than an XLR. No matter the dynamics, nothing. It's just how it works. So, Benny Boy talking shit about our boy Soul Bro number 3. So Benny goes, one final thing. I hate how he puts down YouTuber who use USB's microphones. Despite the fact that a lot of YouTubers who use them are highly respected and have top-notch production values. This guy named Trent responds, it's not like they're trying to sound exactly like they would in a TV production. In my opinion, as long as I can hear them, who cares what kind of microphone they use? If they wanted to be professional, yeah, that makes sense. But if they're just making YouTube videos, what's the big deal? Well, you know, I'm sure you guys get that, like, the big deal is that it will elevate your content, you know, it just immeasurably to have better sound than worse sound. If your voice is clearer, if your voice is EQ'd better, if you have better dynamics, if you have a better recording setup, it's always going to elevate your content, right? It's not about being an industry professional, but it is about having some modicum of professionalism in what you do. And that's totally lost on Benny, because if it's not a bunch of contorted, meat-looking, weird women bending over with their big, long peanut heads, he doesn't get it. He has a shit mic, and we're going to find that out too. He has a very shit mic. And these are just some facts about Benny. He's a cat person, he's very hard to offend, and for some reason, he enjoys sweating. And that brings us to his art. So, once again, we dive into the depravity of DeviantArt, and we get to take a look at some of Ben the Looney's works. So these are a lot of his original characters that we're going to go through first. So, guys.
Mr. Enter did find great success despite having a shit mic.
Yeah, I would say he is an outlier, DePreston. And you and I both know that his content's not very good. He was just the first guy to show up. And that gets you a lot of points initially. So what the fuck is happening here? Yeah, what the fuck is happening here? Between the head, the Joker smile, the lopsided titties, the fucking triangle fucking... like the triangle waist. Like her waist looks like an isosceles triangle. The proportions, the fucking claw fingers on one hand. And as we continue through his content, you're going to notice he's very fond of this one pose. Oh, God! All right. Guys, what are we thinking? He looks like a pinto bean. This is the slow girl in class who's got the BBL. Yeah, that's right. That's right. And her hat's like really tiny and weird. The proportions are despicably bad.
Sherry Shade O'Reilly, the shy plump girl.
Ew, nigga. Ew. Plump. Oh, the shy plump girl with dark fantasies. I have to save the Ben voice as we progress. And this is his character, Kraz. And I'll be real, Kraz looks like an entirely different woman every time he draws her. And boy, you know, I'm a fan of representation where it works, but like, good fucking God. What is happening here? The shoulders, the fucking like emaciated body, the extremely long navel. What the fuck is this? He's a hips guy? Yeah, a lot of times you can tell what, like, these guys are into. So, hips. He draws a lot of women with, like ab definition. Like, not full abs, but, like, toned stomachs. And then, yeah, like, tits, obviously. This nigga gross, man. So, we stay losing looking at this shit. And like, I know that's not supposed to be buck teeth, but they look like buck teeth. She's got the melanoma sunspots, you know, she's got freckles that look like she has cancer. Just her body looks like a fucking tube of meat. Oh, man. But yeah, his favorite pose is he always has one hand on the hip. Always. Like, you're gonna see it so often. The more we... Okay. Obviously, a lot of this is gonna be in SFW, so we're only looking at the SFW stuff. If you guys really fuck with this, I might do, like, an Odyssey version and just look at all of his porn stuff. She's only doing this because she wants to. Nice. You'd love to see it. Oh, God. Like, the hands. The hand, the back, the titties, the waist. Oh. You should. Everyone who does art should feel good about their art looking at this shit. But, like, the fact that he's this bad at art and he's such a, like, unapologetic coomer. It's, yeah. 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 So let's look at a bit of his fan art, shall we? Oh, fuck. What the fuck? Oh, Christ. Fucking Chuck Berry with the crossed eyes. I think that's Sammy Davis, and he looks like Tyler, the Creator. What the fuck has he done to these niggas, man? Who's here? All right. So, John Lee Hooker. All right. Doesn't look like him. Lead Belly. Robert Johnson. B.B. King. Oh, that's Howlin' Wolf. Yeah, no, I couldn't tell. Big Bill Brunzi, Howlin' Wolf, Muddy Waters, and Lil Walter. Well, he's got a pretty strong understanding of the blues, but I might be singing the blues looking at this dog shit, man. Like, good fucking God. It isn't, Inquisitor. Oh, man, the sketches. We're not going to clown on the sketches, though, because they're unfinished. They're unfinished, okay? It's not fair to clown on his unfinished works. We only rip on the polished stuff. But, like, let's take a look at his fan art here. So, oh. Holy fuck. That's fucking Inspector Gadget's daughter. How old is Inspector Gadget's daughter? I think she's like 9. I think this character's 9 years old. And why'd he give her... Why? I don't even want to say it. It's so fucking icky. God damn. Just fucking goth Lincoln Loud. When I'm done, it's gonna be the quiet house. Oh, he's got the Rickies on though. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Why is he packing so much heat? I rewatched the episode Space Invader and forgot about Lincoln dressing up like a goth for a scene. So I decided to draw it. Why did you give him a bulge? Good fucking God. All right, what we got here? This is like a personification of Nickelodeon. Oh, she got the feet out. Okay, it really is Nickelodeon. Dan approved. Schneider approved. That's going into Schneider's bakery. So this is Lenny. I think, is Lenny of age or is she like 17? Lenny Loud may be dumb, but that doesn't stop her from having fun. Yeah, okay. All right. Sure, my nigga, sure. Hey, shout out Doom, young Doomavelli. Yeah, I like my man with a micro penis. You know what I like, Esmeralda? Not a child having a bulge. That's what I don't like. I also don't like a fraud nigga, a snitch nigga, or a bitch nigga, as Chief Keef once said. Oh, yes. Yeah, cats, we're gonna look at that too. So, I briefly alluded to it, but Pan Pizza, Rebel Taxi himself, did have Ben the Loony on an episode of his podcast. And you bet we're going to hop around that and crack the fuck up at it. I'm a huge Pan fan. I've always been a fan of Pan Pizza. But that nigga does some dumb shit, let me tell you. So here's another child. This is Ami from Hi Hi Puffy Ami Yumi. Why does she look like she got skin surgery on her stomach? Like, good fucking God. And the claw hands. This bitch is built like Roger from American Dad. Like, what the fuck is occurring here? Why is this happening? Why is any of this happening? Oh. And then if we're going to look at Ami, we got to look at Yumi. What the fuck are these proportions? Star, you're not wrong. There are a lot of problems in the cartoon community. I don't absolve all of them, okay? I just like his funny reviews. So pretty disgusting, pretty goddamn horrible. Yeah, and the list goes on. Like, there's just so much to wade through. Let me take a look at some donos, some tips, some tricks. See what we got here, because I think a few came in. So, looks like we got a couple from Victor here. Victor with the one saying, excuse me, what the fuck is this? And Victor with another one saying, tell me you're racist without saying you're racist. Well, Ben the Looney also has some interesting feelings on blackface that we'll get into. I fucking kid you not. I kid you not. And then we have $10 from the Cat Warrior saying, you deserve a little something for subjecting yourself to this. Greatly appreciated, Cat Warrior. This is pain. This is painful. Very painful. Cats, you're not wrong. None of you were wrong about Pan Pizza. I don't want to say anything. I'm a fan, but he's a deeply flawed man. I don't endorse a lot of what he does and says. So, let's take a look at what the man does in his spare time. When he's not looking at, when he's not making art, excuse me, he's probably looking at art. And what kind of art does men usually look at? Well, I see a lot of blacked out images, and I'm not signing into this shit. But you see a trend. You see a motherfucking trend, don't you guys? You see a lot of titties. You see a lot of minors. A lot of titties and a lot of minors. And minors with titties. Hey, there's okay, though. That's cool. And there's Vash. Some eye bleach in between. Oh, yep. Like, you look at someone's favorites and it tells you a lot about who they really are. Well, YouTube's favorite idiot. I don't think there's a lot wrong with Pan. I just think he's kind of autistic, and he talks about teenage cartoon characters too much. But I think he's cut down on that quite a bit recently. So, again, I'm not saying anything about Pan, other than he, like many cartoon review people, probably need to go outside, touch a bit of turf, figure it out, you know? I know his partner Mango does a lot to handle him. Depreston with $4.99 saying Justin Trudeau also has funny feelings about blackface. Yeah, funny enough, he does. He really does, doesn't he? I'm not going through the whole Pan Pizza podcast. Stop asking me. Maybe at some point we'll do a Pizza Party podcast episode where we watch the lowlights of the Pizza Party podcast. Because forget, all right, Cosmodor, yeah, horrible, disgusting creature. Pan also had fucking Richard Cuda on there. Richard Cuda, a knothole resident Mr. Sonic Diapers himself was on his podcast at one point too. The Sonic Diaper guy who tried to make a fucking Sonic movie but was too busy pissing himself. That guy was also on the Pan Pizza podcast. He got some bad guests, man. Precious Leaf. Ooh. No, Esmeralda, like, send me some info or comment about Precious Leaf. I'll look into that for sure. And if anyone ever has any suggestions for someone really bizarre, by all means. Yeah, Star, we should do the Pizza Party podcast. Man, I'm gonna make some powerful enemies talking this way. Some powerful autistic enemies. So, this is Bone Tunes. This is the account of, and don't mind my Twitter. It's specifically made for this stuff. I am not Maximilian Thermidor from Armored Core 4 Answer. That's not my real name. Don't worry. But this is Bone Tunes, which is his 18 plus account. And we're not looking at a lot of it. But it's quite dire. You do see, though, he has improved quite a bit, proportion-wise. So if you want to find out more about Ben's NSFW stuff, check out Bone Tunes on Twitter.com. It's very, 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 very disgusting. But let's take a look at some of the content the man makes. Got a donation here from Baneblade for Icelandic Kroner, right? ISK300, is that Icelandic Kroner? I ask every stream because it throws me off. I'm sick, but funny stream make me feel better. Well, thank you, Baneblade. Thank you that you're here. Have I heard of a lol count named Chris Chandler? I'm afraid I haven't, depressed. And oh, I might have to look into that person. Are they interesting? Like, what do they do? What makes them that way? What's the attraction? So this is a animated project that our friend Ben did. So 11 weeks in the making and the hard work paid off. Watch my 1 minute tribute to martial arts movies and anime. All right, excited, very excited. Let me just check that the audio's coming through. Ah, it is not. Damn. Absolute Africans got me pressed, dog. All right. Should be working now. Let me just make sure it's centered. All right. That should work. Are you fucking kidding me? Man, I hate OBS so goddamn much. This happens every single goddamn time. All right, Christ. Hell yeah. We in it. All right, so this is it's a showdown of epic proportions. Pretty exciting stuff here. Bottom text, that's not mean. I had a really good artist fix my avatar for me. Because the artist who did my avatar previously was a piece of shit who may or may not have done something very silly in a certain community that led to a certain DFV. So shout out Egg. Egg, you're the best artist ever. And I hope that weird dinosaur lady is in a gutter somewhere. It is ass. NCID with $2. I gotta rewind to catch up on this. Oh God. Yeah. This is gonna be a fast one. There's a lot going on here. Sadly, yes. Sadly, I am Canadian. Damn, he got the toes out, though. Oh, shit, why he vibe like that? Also, Nameless, very sorry to hear, but very glad that you're with us. Hopefully we can make you laugh a bit. Why he doing that?
Get back to work, you slacker.
So that was directed, animated, and edited by Ben Tannehill. And, you know, word to the wise, even if you're making a student project, don't upload it online, man. And certainly don't upload it on your fucking YouTube channel where you talk about porn and dox yourself. Like, come on! What are you doing? Unreal. Unfucking real. So yeah, that was quite the masterpiece, but we're moving on to his magnum opus, other than the Shadman video, which is Lost to Time and archived through people's rants. We're going to take a look at Ben's top 10 hottest women. So there he is. There's our boy. There's the man. Hopefully, again, audio comes through. Oh, shit. Hi, fangirl. How's it going? Yeah, Ben is not good. He's not a good guy.
Welcome back to Ben's Top 10.
See, this is why you don't use a USB mic.
And when I was a kid, girls were considered icky. As I've said several times before, I love cartoons. Also, I'm a guy, so I love women. Most of the time, I'm not too picky.
Well, Preston, I think your expectations may be subverted throughout this video.
Icky when it comes to girls. I don't care about looks. It's the character.
I'm the sweetest guy any girl could ask for. And I still can't get a date. It's funny how that works. Yeah, it's because you're a creep weirdo.
That I care for. But from time to time, my ancestral love of women comes out and I can't help but to drool over good-looking girls. Therefore, I love animated women. Women have been a staple of animation since...
Back when it was cartoons that taught us about the birds and the bees. What? When did cartoons teach you about the facts of life? Damn, this nigga's parents fucked him up. Oh yeah, he love questing hard, Kaz.
It's creation, and it's the women that usually drive...
No, fangirl, you aren't, but this guy's kind of like the Shadow to Guptil Sonic, if that makes sense.
...the guy viewers into a cartoon, and making them keep coming back for more.
Coming.
Due to me being extreme...
keep coming.
...extremely cartoon and girl...
There's nothing wrong in showing affection towards cartoon characters. I think there is, especially if those cartoon characters still pack juice boxes in their lunch.
Crazy. I'm going to do a top 10 list of, in my opinion, the birds hottest and the animated feet. Women in animation. And I'll do my best to try and maintain my sanity. Hello, nurse! Sorry, I only have one rule for this list. No animals. Well.
Oh, man, that's where he draws the line. He's just like, I'm not one of those filthy, degenerate furries. I like women with flesh!
Let's stop talking and start drooling. Here are my top 10 hottest animated
the
women.
Birds and the bees.
Number 10, Jenny XJ9 Wakeman from My Life as a...
Immediate... Okay, so this guy goes, no animals, no furries, immediately names a fucking robot. His first pick is a robot, and it's an underage robot. I understand that robots technically... would not be aged, but she's literally designed to be a teenager. It's in the fucking title. Yo, this nigga Sheldon, man. Like, This guy is the kind of guy who didn't realize that Sheldon in My Life as a Teenage Robot was a reflection of people like him. Yeah, sadly, no Rouge the Bat. I know. I'm sorry. No Batussy. Only Robussy.
Teenage Robot. Jeannie is basically the normal teenage girl, except she's mechanical and she kicks alien and bad.
621, this is Handler Walter. You're gonna have to have sex with that AC.
Guy, but Jeannie spends most of her time doing normal teenage girl things, shopping, hanging out with friends.
The mission is simple, 621. Stick your dick in the robot. Yeah, it's gonna hurt at first, but you get used to it.
And staring at boys. The hotness of this character comes from her casual wear. Basically, she walks around half naked all the time, with a bulk representing her belly.
Thanks, Nora. Thank you, Nora Wakeman, for going, "Ooh, XJ9, I want to make sure that disgusting weird perverts ogle you for decades."
Button. I wish more girls were allowed to walk around like that in real life. Anyway, what also makes Jeannie great is that she's voiced by my favorite voice actress, Janice Kaway, and she gives Jeannie the perfect voice for her. I put Jeannie pretty low on this list because, well, she's a robot. However, Jeannie is still a hottie that may have been the only reason I watched this show she came from.
She was the only reason you watched a very good cartoon? This nigga sucks! My Life as a Teenage Robot's a great cartoon. If you haven't watched it, you should watch it. If you're into American animation, it's very good. It's very funny, very well animated, great action. The list goes on of reasons to watch that show. This nigga watched it because he's a disgusting coomer, and that's it?
9. Bulma from Dragon Ball Z. I might not be that big a fan of anime, but my favorite is Dragon Ball Z. Growing up, the two reasons I watched DBZ was for the action.
Yes, Dale. Yes, it is.
Action and this blue-haired hot tamale. One of my...
This blue-haired hot tamale. We gotta run it back.
Growing up, the two reasons I watched DBZ was for the action and this blue-haired hot tamale.
Bulma, I think Bulma's of age in DBZ. She's an adult woman. In Dragon Ball, she's a teenager.
One of my favorite things about anime is that kids' animes aren't afraid to contain material that would never even be touched upon by cartoons over here. And big example of this would be Bulma. Bulma's character is mostly the stereotypical damsel in distress, but when she's angry, she lets the boys know about it. Her hotness comes from the occasional swimsuit, cleavage, and bathroom footage.
Bathroom footage? Bathroom footage? Thanks to Preston. I appreciate you, homie. Thanks for holding out with me, man. Appreciate you, dog.
What stunk about this was a lot of the stuff was cut out for when it aired in the U.S. Thank you very much, American society. And so I didn't get to see a lot of Bulma's hotness. But thanks to the DVDs, I'm seeing both uncut action and hotness of Bulma. And also, why in the heck did Vegeta and Bulma get married?
It's because Vegeta got that dick. Vegeta got that short king dick.
Number 8. Stacy from Phineas and Ferb. I know.
Oh, no! This is undeniably a child. This is just a fucking, like, 13-year-old. Are you kidding me? Vegeta absolutely lays pipe. That guy destroyed planets. You don't think he can slang dick? That's a whole-ass child.
Expect to put someone from a recent show on this one, nor did I expect modern cartoons are able to make hot female characters anymore. But here she is. Stacy is basically Candace's best friend in the show. She's basically the stereotypical teenage girl.
Teenage.
I don't know what I see in her, but I just think she's hot. I like her tan skin, and her being Japanese helps a little bit. But one main hotness trait I like about this character is this.
Oh, no. Yo, but for real, she built like a Slim Jim, probably because she's a child!
What the heck kind of bikini is this? It looks like something out of a Picasso painting.
What? It's just a regular ass bikini with like a sarong and some frills. This nigga does not get out. Good. Good though. I hope he doesn't get out.
Who cares? She looks hot in it. Stacy may not have much character, and she may not make it much appearances in the show.
But she's Japanese.
She's one of the hottest women you'll find in a modern cartoon, even if she is a teenager. Number 7, Daphne Blake from Scooby-Doo. Let's face it.
Damn, bad bitch alert. Fucking all the bad bitch on a Tuesday.
The Scooby-Doo franchise has been milked to death. The show has had more spinoffs than a 70s sitcom. But one of the only good things about this show continuing is this purple-wearing hottie. She's basically that person who does absolutely...
Anytime he talks about women, it's just, he fucking sounds so gross. This purple-wearing hottie. Oh, this is... I'd love to sniff her.
Absolutely nothing. I bet she was created to give the teenage boy...
Nutty Buddy, at this time, he was 24. At present, he's probably around 30-something.
Always something to stare at. Her hotness comes from her curves, her pose, and her nice bikini. With pink and purple being my favorite colors, that's definitely a winner. Again, Daphne may not have much character to her, but she's definitely one of the only reasons to keep Scooby-Doo going, just so us guys can see more.
I'm sure that's exactly why popular franchise Scooby-Doo is still in circulation. For the fucking 7 perverts. Depressed in with $1.99. This guy is like the evil Coomer twin of Guptill. I know, I said it. If Guptill is Sonic, he's Shadow.
More of her. Number 6. Frankie Foster.
Come on, man. Just pick... Alright, you picked one adult. Just pick... Pick a second adult. All you gotta do, pick 2 adults. Be attracted to an adult challenge impossible for this man. Good God.
From Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends. Frankie is basically the housekeeper of Foster's and has to do so much work to keep the house in order, and she even is a victim to a lot of abuse. However, she's a sexy character that we feel sorry for.
Sexy? The amount of times I watched Foster's Home, you know, as a kid, as a teenager, and as an adult, respectively, I never saw this character and went, wow, man, whoa. Like, she's just a girl. Now, Frankie's a teenager. She's, like, right at the cusp, though, so... I think she might be an adult later in it, because I think they actually age throughout the series, though. Zuki, stop!
She does have character to her, though. A lot of times...
Oh, Frankie's an adult? Is she an adult? Okay, alright, that's good. Alright, then Zuki, don't stop. Zuki, do not stop, then. Okay. Jesus Christ. But... Alright, so he's got 2 adults. Got 2 adults so far. Damn. Okay, alright, my error.
She protests against the work she has to do, and often has a heated rivalry with Mr. Harriman. She knows how to kick butt. Her hotness comes from a nice...
She'd even beat the crap out of a guy she was on a date with. I'd love it if she hit me, Ben the Looney, me!
Green sweater, ruby purple hair, showing of her belly button. This weird
showing of her
voice by Grey DeLong.
A bikini? That's a fucking crop top t-shirt. That's not even a crop top. It's just like a baby tee, you know? Like it's just like a baby doll cut tee. This guy has never met a fucking woman. Christ almighty. Showing her belly button.
Lysel. And the fan art.
Damn, yay. It'd be stupid to diss you.
Arts. Oh, the fan arts.
Oh, nigga.
She's so hot, she captures the love of a prepubescent boy and an imaginary friend.
Good joke, Alan.
And dang, that's something. Anyway, Frankie is a sexy woman that when she's angry, she'll let you know about it.
Yeah, idiot, I believe Gray DeLille, right? Well, she goes by Gray Griffin now because she's married, but I believe a Scooby-Doo animation used AI voices, and she was quite upset about that. And, you know, there was kind of a battle between, like, voice act people and AI people.
Number 5. Red Hot Riding Hood from Tex Avery Cartoons.
Alright, that's pretty fucking obscure. I think he's a big Tex Avery guy, which makes me sad because I like Tex Avery too, but not for the weird Coomer reasons he does.
This is a big example as to why cartoons were made for adults back in the days. Red is basically a lounge singer who is basically the adult version of Red Riding Hood. Red always catches the eyes of wolves in some of the most hilarious cartoons ever made. Hotness comes from her curves that laugh anatomy laws in the face and her...
She did buy AI art. That's right, Dale. Like, for, I think it was for, like, a convention appearance. She had people sign AI art of Daphne instead of getting, like, a commissioned piece or official piece. Yeah, these voice actors are dumb as shit, but, you know, I mean, I can understand, like, not wanting your voice stolen, but... Yeah, she should have just paid an artist to draw Daphne for her prints, dumbass.
Incredibly hot voice. Back in the day, women weren't allowed to be nude or be in bikinis in films, so this is the closest we got to a revealing outfit. Most people would consider her number one hottest anime.
That's a low point. Like,
if only she was naked in the movie.
Hey, women, but I still got 4 more spots to fill.
You'd be right, Greg.
Number 4. Misty from Pokemon.
Guys. I just can't fucking handle this guy. And we're not even deep yet. Misty! Misty!
Pokemon. Another anime character. Misty is the main female character in the Pokemon series. For the first bunch of seasons,
if she only took wings.
Misty is one of Ash's best friends, and she helps Ash along the journey to...
And she has a ponytail that resembles a Native American.
...be the ultimate Pokemon master. Unlike most female characters, Misty is also independent and can be tough when she wants to be.
And she can play in the Himalayas for hours.
Her hotness comes from her red hair, her swimsuits, her mermaid outfit, and her walking around with her belly showing. What's different about Misty is...
Belly. Belly. Belly.
She has no navel. In my opinion, I like anime women with no navel better. I don't know why. I just think it looks better. Anyway...
She doesn't not have a navel. She's got Daisy... She's got, like, Daisy Dukes that go above her navel. She possesses a belly button. There are characters in Pokemon who have belly buttons. This thing is so gross.
Wait, Misty is the main reason I woke up every Saturday morning.
Ew, belly button.
Saturday morning cartoons. Misty was so hot, she was worth watching over 300 episodes.
Yeah, Curtio, he's on that anti
show just to get lots of looks at her. Number 3, Starfire from Teen Titan.
Belly.
Starfire is a Tamaranian warrior who lands on Earth to join the Teen Titans. She is naive to Earth customs, and she sometimes has a difficult time getting adapted to Earth materials. Starfire is also tough when she needs to be, and one strong woman, I kid you not. Her hotness contributes to her sweet voice, her long ruby hair, and she also flies around with her belly hanging out.
Belly! She flies around with that belly out. Yeah, guys, I'm kind of forgetful. What was this group of heroes called? They were the something titans? What kind of titans were they? Can you guys tell me what kind of titans these guys were?
Were they the above the age of consent Titans? Oh, they must have been the adult Titans. They're definitely not the senior Titans, though. Can you guys remind me what kind of Titans they were?
Again, she doesn't have Navel. Well, she's an alien, so I guess that's okay. Teen Titans is one of my favorite shows, but a lot of times I forget all about the storylines and the action, and I just stare at...
Thanks for jogging my fucking memory. They're the Teen Titans, you pervert.
Star.
The Adult Titans, if I recall correctly. Adult Titans!
Fire. I can't help myself. If more aliens look like this, all I could say is, bring on the invasion! Number two, Ariel from The Little Mermaid. I knew I had to put a Disney princess on here. It was tough to choose between Ariel and Jasmine, but I had to go with Ariel.
Legally unable to consent. Teen Titans.
Like most Disney princesses, Ariel is wanting to get away from her boring life and try new things, but mostly...
need to get slip-signed by a parent. Teen Titans.
She's looking for some love. Ariel's hotness comes from, well, she's a friggin' mermaid! Mermaids are friggin' awesome, as well as sexy.
I feel like I have fucking food poisoning listening to him talk.
Any species where half-naked women is not only allowed, but a custom, I'm so there. She also has an amazing voice, and she has a barrage of sisters that are equally as hot as her.
A barrage?
Bottom line, Ariel is without a doubt the hottest Disney princess, and a good excuse as to why guys can watch Disney movies. And my number one hottest animated woman, it's a three-way tie.
Between three children. Get in the TV, like the writer of the episode of The Splinter should be off of TV. Yeah, that's right, Depreston. Adachi Mr. Enter would be the best Adachi.
Ami, Yumi, and Julie from Hi Hi Puffy Ami Yumi. I couldn't help.
Those are whole ass children.
I just had to put them on here. If you watched enough of my videos, you'd know I love this show, and what I love most about it is the characters.
I think these girls are like 12 or 13, man.
It was the hotness of these girls that made me want to watch this show. I was going through puberty when this show came on, and when I saw an advertisement...
Why is he telling me about his puberty, nigga? Why is he talking to me like this?
With the girls in their bikinis, I had to jump on the bandwagon to see them. Ami is hot because she's got to have the cutest voice ever. If you listen to her voice, you can't resist it.
Star Julie was the former bandmate of Yumi before Ami joined. There was a series of episodes about that, but she was ousted from the band soon after and then plotted revenge.
Yumi is hot because she is one...
Oh, he had to redo that take, but he didn't cut it out. Yumi's hot. Grape, if this guy was my roommate, I would move. $4.99 from Depreston, this man would see the kids next door up next and immediately get bricked up. Stop. Oh, number four, number five. Oh,
one tough girl. Aunt Julie is hot because she has a sweet voice, she has a little bit of her belly showing, and she's...
Belly. You've got a belly out.
It's crazy. Another thing that contributes to Ami and Yumi's hotness is that they wear a variety of sexy outfits throughout the run of the show, from bikinis to hula outfits to cave girl outfits.
Yeah, bottom text they are, and that they're good musicians, but... You cannot look at these two characters and tell me that they are not fucking kids.
To magician assistants outfits, to pajamas, it's all just nuts. They even look hot in their casual outfits. Simply amazing. Also, I just decided to add Julie onto this because I can't resist her beauty either. She may have only been in one episode, but she made an impact. I put these girls all at number one because I believe they are all equal.
I swear to God, if this bitch doesn't show her belly, I'm cutting her the fuck off.
Equally hot. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if the reason why Cartoon Network canceled this show was because the girls were too hot.
Only three of those are adults I want off this ride. Says Dr. Negus be wildin' for $2. Well, the ride hasn't even begun, dog. You just got to the front of the line. We're on it. We're on it now.
That is just awesome. They're geometric shapes. At the same time, these were the girls that got me into this show, and I was forever changed after it. Thanks to the beauty of these two girls and this one extra girl, I found my favorite cartoon ever. On top of that, they have the best characteristics you could ever ask for in a girl. I love all three.
You know, the way that this show works, too, every episode of Puffy AmiYumi, they get stuck in a bad situation. So I'm just picturing Kaz coming up to them and going like, "Girls, girls, quick! We have a disgusting pedophile to do a private performance for!"
Kaz, are you serious?
No, he's paying top dollar!
So, there's my top 10 hottest animated women. I hope you enjoyed it. Tell me what you think about these lovely ladies, and tell me if there are some other...
There's a sex offender who is paying top dollar for us to play!
...animated women out there that I missed. I'm Ben, and I'm signing out.
Cartoon wasn't mid. Cartoon was dope. I love that cartoon. I hate this guy for ruining it for me. So... We're gonna take a look into the lewd mind of Ben the Loony as he justifies his predilection, let's say. And yes, he was on Channel Frederator because they give fucking Frederator status to anyone who talks about cartoons, even this fucking pervert.
Hey folks, Ben the Loony here. Those of you who have followed me for the longest time have been presented with this image of a good old country boy who was golly gee innocent that he didn't even want to swear in his own videos, always drank chocolate milk, and the only thing he worried about was cartoons and movies to watch. I was always a crusader for family-friendly entertainment, as I wanted to make videos that kids, and to a certain extent, adults, could enjoy. Mostly for the protection of my little cousins and family members who support me by watching my videos. I'm no stranger to trying to keep a squeaky clean image. The impression that seems to go around is the Midwest is full of polite, God-fearing people, welcoming neighbors with open arms, and full of families who get together every Sunday to eat meatloaf, corn, and potatoes. I can say that the environment that I was raised in has inspired my personality. I consider myself a very laid-back individual who...
God, I hate how he draws fingers. He draws these, like, long, disgusting claws because he can't actually put time into drawing a finger.
...who treats people I meet with respect and kindness, and only shows his mean side when either me or one of my friends are antagonized. Now, as for those of you new to my channel, taking everything I said into consideration... What would you think of me if I told you that I like to draw? Drawing? What's wrong with that?
Yeah, what's wrong with drawing, Ben? Elaborate. Enlighten us. Butch Hartman art style, for sure, man. This nigga just drawing straight-ass lines. What is bro yammering about? Yeah, oh, he's meant to tell us why he's a coomer. Don't worry, don't worry. We're gonna find out.
Everybody has a hobby. What would you think if I told you I like to draw nudity?
Nigga, why are you saying this to me in the fucking workplace lunchroom? Like, that's what I would say. And, you know, this kind of person, like, he, back when he was a janitor or working at McDonald's, he would probably say, "What would you think about my drawing nudity?" to someone as they're eating a fucking McDouble. On their McDonald's, like, lunch break at 20 minutes, he'd probably... What's wrong with this man?
Nudity? Big deal. Every famous artist draws nude figures. It's just the natural human body, after all. Now, what would you think if I told you I like to draw those same nude bodies having...
Same nude bodies as cartoon women?
Intercourse with each other. Oh, Oh my. Not so golly gee innocent anymore, now am I? I think it's time a lot of you got to hear a side of me that I hid from my online persona for the longest time.
For real, it's just like the way he, like, says stuff is inherently gross. Even when he's not saying, like, particularly gross things, he sounds so nasty.
Well, what would you think if I drew those characters having intercourse and kissing and touching one another?
Get away from me, is what I would say.
I'm, as far back as I can remember, to my puberty years, I've always been fascinated by the human body and sexual media. Growing up in a strong Christian household, with balls bluer than Violet Beauregard after a trip to the chocolate factory, I wasn't allowed to look at any pictures.
Oh shit, it's done? Yo, don't tell me that shit is done. That is ass. Nigga. Nah, that is cheeks. You didn't shade it. Are you fucking kidding me? Yeah, great, but sure is.
Pictures that could be taken sexually. I can remember one instance when my mother gave me a...
No, it was done! He didn't... Unreal. Unfucking real. Yeah, it is very, White Bowser-esque. I'm sure Ben the Looney, even though he's not a big anime fan, might actually enjoy, Tawawa on a Monday.
Stern talking to when she caught me just doing a Google search of women in bikinis. Pornography was just something I heard about in more adult cartoons I watched, like South Park, Futurama, or Family Guy. So me, not being tech savvy, had no idea how to view it.
Oh, I should remember the time when I showed Ben the Looney pornography.
I also grew up around peers who watched porn sites freely and would constantly brag about how much they enjoyed it, while I just had to sit there and listen, curious about what all the hype was about. However, I had to please my hormones somehow, and my outlet for getting my sick kicks became cartoons.
Ugh.
It was the best I can do in my situation. I'd wait for any episode involving my favorite female character showing a little more skin, whether it be swimsuits, bikinis, or even just wearing a smaller shirt that showed navel.
Navel!
Satisfy me. Not having access to the hardcore stuff also forced me to use my imagination.
Yeah, that's correct, Enfa. Like, this guy was, like, a very vehement advocate for cooming as hard as possible. The guy wanted to coom, and the world wouldn't let him coom.
To use what little info I had about the human body to try to let my fantasies out in my head, this helped spark my imagination for the more lewd side of my creative mind. My first attempts at drawing seriously that didn't involve childhood doodles.
Yeah, sorry, Banebite, don't lose your way!
...those were drawings of my favorite cartoon characters in swimsuits. These drawings have been lost with time, but my point is that sexuality has always been a part of my interests in some form or another. I was a horny kid with a need to unleash my perverted fantasy.
Oh, unleash is not a good word for what you're describing. Unleash is only a few actions away from a big no-no.
He's in a creative way. And that eventually followed me when I started posting art online. My feeble attempts at drawing back in the day led me to trying to sneak in some more arousing art pieces in some way or another on my old DeviantArt account. However, thanks to how I was raised, my shyness and fear of public ridicule caused me to delete and shoot down any attempts I had of drawing that kind of art.
You should be afraid of public ridicule. You should be afraid of this. Like, this is not advantageous, and you're not even a good enough artist to monetize it, all right? In that order. In that fucking order. You're one, not good enough at art to make money or to generate any sort of positivity from your art. Yes, you have like 20K subs, but that's 20K subs across near a decade and a half. That's pretty fucking bad. All right, that's pretty ass for what he does. That's downright terrible. This guy has basically been making videos since YouTube started, and he's got 20K subs. That's not great.
But beyond that, he's a dog shit fucking artist. He doesn't even draw good lewd stuff, and he exclusively draws minors. This guy is, I'm just baffled at him. I'm baffled.
Eventually, I discovered other artists who not only drew lewd art, but they...
Also, fangirl, just keep on plugging away, because it just takes a lot of time and practice, but if anything, see this pervert's art as an opportunity to grow and to develop as an artist.
Embraced it and made a name for themselves doing it. I was taught that pornography was evil and...
Yeah, Starlake... Like, he did a collab with Pan Pizza, who is one of the biggest people in that cartoon community. And that didn't generate anything for him. And again, we're talking like 15 years of making content. This guy's got like 600 plus videos. And a Frederator partnership. 23K is bad for what he does.
No good comes of it. Yet... Here were artists like Zone,
as you should be,
Shadman,
you should be scared,
Gurf, and Big.
Oh, let's run it back. He names the Big S.
Yet, here were artists like Zone, Shadman, Gurf, and Big Dead Alive, who are making a living in an evil business with lots of good coming their way. It's them.
Yeah, lots of good coming to Shadman. This aged like fucking milk. I get it would probably be about 15. When did he start his channel? This is 6 years ago. And this is one of his, like, more modern videos. So let's go to oldest. All right, 12 years. 12 years. That's terrible. That's fucking terrible.
Then I decided, if they can do it, why can't I? Why do I draw lewd? Why not? It's my belief that humans are sexual creatures by nature. Why wouldn't we be? It goes back to the time of cavemen when everybody walked...
Yeah, of course, he names Zone and Shadman back to back.
...walked around naked, and guys would screw any woman he could get his monkey paws on.
Run that back, Turbo.
Everybody walked around naked... Guys would screw any woman he could get his monkey paws on.
A guy would screw any woman he could get his monkey paws on? Christ, nigga! One of his artist spotlights was Shad, but he's since privated it because of all the backlash. Which is a shame, because it's very funny. But all of his other artist spotlights aren't much better than Shad. And we'll be looking at those too. Oh, look at the navel.
To build up his pack, and then draw it on cave walls for the amusement of his friends. Sex leads to the creation of human life. He asked me, that's...
Oh, he collabed with Enter as well? Not surprising. And, I mean, again, the fact that he's collabed with two of the biggest people in cartoon YouTube, Pan Pizza and Mr. Enter, at different points in his life, and he couldn't use that momentum in any way, says volumes about this moron.
It's the most beautiful thing on the planet. We all have certain genders we're attracted to, and we all have kinks that we prefer. As long as these
he
kinks
did
are
say
within
he was
reason,
ace. He also said he was bi, so like you can never take anything this guy says like without a grain of salt. He said he was bi, he said he was ace, and then he pretended to act like a 1960s pervert.
Shame to them, no matter what social stigmas out there try to label us as pervs for him. It baffles me that sex and porn is so taboo in a world where a photograph of a woman being hung from a tree and beaten by a man while innocent bystanders look on and do nothing to...
What the fuck is this man talking about? And yeah, Goose, he was. We'll pull it up. We'll pull it up soon.
A helper can go on to win Pulitzer Prizes. While a photo of a male and female commencing in the very act that created the same people who were offended by it is disgusting, and anyone who shows any signs of liking that kind of stuff is called a pervert, a sexist...
Why does he like sex so much? Like, you know, I know that's a silly question, but, like, sex is just sex, man. Like, especially if you're fucking having it, like, yeah, it's great, but, you know, it's not the end-all be-all. Like, if you're in a relationship, if you're dating someone, if you're married, and you have sex, that's great. That's awesome. It feels good. And, yeah, there's a purpose behind it occasionally, too, if you're trying to have kids or whatever. But this guy is, like, deifying having sex. He's, like, treating sex like it's some sort of ancient temple.
Pig, a rape enabler, you name it. Oh! Being interested in sex is no different from being interested in TV shows, movies, video games, or books.
The Coomerist, random.
If you're going to attack somebody who likes sex, you might as well hate them for liking food, water, or breathing. The basic elements that human nature needs to survive. Now, I understand that's a private topic
that not a lot of people like
to talk about. I'm not one who likes to bring up my favorite porn star at the Thanksgiving table in front of my family members.
Why would you? Why the fuck would you?
First, it's good to have filters around others. I want to talk to my uncle about the same things I talk about with my best friend. I'm allowed to be more loose around my friends because they share the same interests as me and understand where I'm coming from. That being said, it's possible my uncle might be thinking of the same fantasies I think of, but he grew up in a generation where they were taught not to talk about that kind of stuff because it's the work of the devil in ya. It's perfectly okay to not be interested in porn or anything sexual in general, but don't try to ridicule others who might be into that kind of stuff, and you want to ban because, oh, my feelings. My love for sexual stuff also...
Yeah, but even despite having a high libido, like Esmeralda, for example, like, you can have a high libido, you can be, like, very sexually active, or you can be attuned to your sexuality, but you can also understand when it's inappropriate or weird to sexualize things, or to be a sexually charged person, right? Let's say you're hanging out with your friends at dinner, you wouldn't say... My partner made me blah, blah, blah. You know, I was able to fucking squirt across the room because my partner fingered me so hard. Like, you wouldn't say that. You wouldn't say things like that in a regular situation. But someone like Ben the Loony seems, like, so willing to talk about this stuff in situations where it would be deemed unwarranted or upsetting. Also... This kind of brings up a good point with Ben. That character Chloe is from We Bare Bears, and that character Chloe is not an adult. And he has drawn lewd of her.
Also goes back to my love of things that are shocking and controversial. I'm one who's all for pushing the boundaries of people's tastes, and using art that is questionable and disgusting to the general public. It's good we have art like that out there that breaks up the monotony of the vanilla sex we're all used to. I believe that the point of drawings and any artwork is doing things that we're limited from doing in real life, due to moral and legal grounds. In a world where people are trying to be PC, not offend anybody, and this very website I'm making this video on is trying to silence people and make them not talk about topics that aren't user-friendly, it's good to have people out there that are trying to challenge social norms and make people think. How ironic that YouTube is trying to cater to millennials, yet they're trying to censor the very things that millennials are interested in. Go figure. Well, I believe in being subversive. Explain the things that are out there that the mainstream doesn't want you to see. To rule in the underground where all the freaks and geeks dwell. I consider myself lucky, more or less thankful, that I live in an online era where I have access to all this artwork and media to consume and take part in. I'm able to...
Oh shit, was I, how long was I muted there? Fuck. I was yelling a lot. So I must have bumped something, my bad. Let me run this back.
Where I have access to all this artwork and media to consume and take part in.
Like, I never watched We Bare Bears, but... Like, this character's like a kid, right? Character's like a whole ass kid. No, Grape, don't feed into it. None of us want to hear it.
I'm able to express myself how I want to, with the only worry being trolls and tumbleites getting their panties in a bunch. complaining about how what I do is wrong. I've always told myself, if you're pissed...
I've been muted for an hour and a half. My boy. Thanks for holding down the fort, though, Depreston. I appreciate it. If it wasn't for you, my incompetence would shine through even more so.
Pissing off people you don't agree with, you're doing something right. People will point out that there is no market for porn. I'm practically throwing away.
Yeah, fangirl, I hate to say yes and yes to both of those things. Yes, Mr. Enter has had multiple dramas in his past. And yes, Ben does think it's okay to show this art, draw it, have a second account dedicated to this style of art. And he flaunts it. And in fact, he's very anti-censorship around it. Spoonbody.
To find success in the industry, and my reputation will be ruined for it. I think a lot of this is merely speculation and based off information being spread by people who have no idea what they're talking about. There are countless stories of porn stars moving on to mainstream acting, with Sasha Grey being an example, as well as artists who make lewd material, not just surviving, but thriving in the media they take part in. Porn is a new...
Okay, so it's confirmed, though, that, like, Chloe is 10 years old. And he has verifiably drawn lewd of her. And in fact, he's drawing her relatively suggestively here.
But don't worry, she's aged up.
Niche market, no doubt about it. That's a market with enough consumers to keep somebody.
Joey, you missed a lot. Ice baby, I'm so sorry. My precious ice baby.
Who takes part in it at a healthy living.
Oh my god, the questions in chat. And they're all horrible. Dale, Sasha Grey is a notable porn star. She's notable because she's a fairly intelligent and cultured porn star. And she starred in a Steven Soderbergh film called The Girlfriend Experience. She was cast because she was a fairly unique personality in the porn space. Soderbergh discovered her and had her in that film. But, you know, ultimately, Sasha Grey is, like, very into philosophy and a lot of other stuff. She's, I don't know, I would say she's a pretty interesting person, but, I mean, she doesn't interest me because, you know, woman. Was she in Saints Row the Third? Yeah, I'm not surprised. She's a unique lady, though. I'll say that much.
My dreams of becoming an animator haven't gone as I planned. Most of it has been my fault, whether it be misguided or just mistakes I made. But life is no straight shot from point A to point B.
I suppose it is
exciting. I've gotten to a part of my life when
you know what? I'm sure his parents don't think that this is exciting. I'm sure his parents think that this is upsetting.
I've asked myself, what do I really want to do? Above all else, I want to do something I enjoy. I don't want to spend most of my time unhappy doing something that my heart isn't into. I really want my work to stand out and be something that people talk about. I've been told that it's easier to consume than it is to create. So, it's my job to do my damnedest to create art that people will constantly come back for.
Sorry.
And I feel like expressing myself with lewd art will be the best way to...
How do Americans say sorry? They say sorry, right? They say sorry. I think it's sorry, right? Because, yeah, Canadians say sorry. They say sore-y. Damn. Y'all Americans crazy clowning the nigga for having a different accent.
To create that kind of content. It's true. I have a lot to learn. My anatomy can use a lot of work, and I'm still in a phase that involves studying. But that gives me drive to succeed. The fact that I'm always learning gives me purpose. If I was perfect and constantly churning out...
Yeah, it's crazy. I'm getting English lessons from a country that, like, barely has an education system.
Great stuff. I would get bored of myself pretty easily. I'm always wanting to challenge myself, discovering what I do well and what I can improve on.
Sorry.
And sometimes, imperfection can be just as beautiful as perfection. So this is probably why a lot of you have been shot, or more or less up and left me for showing my...
What... Why is her hoodie so tight that you can see, like, ab definition? God, I hate his art. I hate his art so much.
My more perverted side. The way I see it, as my audience grew up, and times were changing, it was time for me to adapt and stay relevant.
Thanks, Jameson.
Could you imagine me still making cringy rants on cartoons that aren't even made for people in my age group? I sure as heck couldn't. There comes a time in a creator's life when he needs to put aside the things he's become known for and try something new. To expand his horizons, get out of his comfort zone, and try to be a
He's talking about drawing porn like he's fucking Richard Williams or something. He's talking about this like it's a pursuit. He's picking himself up. He's moving forward. He's elevating art. Dog, you're drawing porn.
A little more daring. I have no shame in what I do, no matter how many.
Yeah, depressed. And I'm thinking of taking him up on that offer, actually.
Naysayers feel I should. I know that deep down, the most prudish individual can't hide their inner sexual needs. Just ask Ted Cruz. No matter what, there's always going to be some kind of porn out there that's going to bother people. And no matter what, there's always going to be people out there who like that sick stuff. And for as long as I'm alive...
$1 from Victor Martinez. Are you fluent in French? I know Claw isn't. I am not fluent, and I don't know a ton, but, you know, I know... Comment ça va tu, ça va bien, ça va mal, et toi, et tu, je m'appelle Bran. Yeah, I don't know a ton of French. I know pretty much enough to get me through a conversation. You know, I know petit pois, I know grand, like just really basic stuff. But like, yeah, we have to take, like, 1 year of French, and then French is an elective in Canada. So if you want to take French, like, throughout high school, that's kind of on you to want to do that.
Life, I'm going to express my sexual imagination in art form. Whether I do it to get people offended and wanting to crucify me, or I just want my followers to have a good wink session with my art. As long as I have hands, a brain, and a penis, I'm going to draw loose.
Hands, brains, and a penis. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Depreston. I apologize for speaking en français. My bad. Omelette du fromage. Brain speak Spanish for the real ones. I don't know a ton of Spanish. I know, Hola, ¿qué pasó? ¿Qué ondas? Me llamo Bran. Yeah, that's pretty much all I know. And I know that huevos are slang for nuts. I know that much.
Lewd artwork. I love sex, I love drawing, and I love causing controversy.
No, I can't say that, Star! Just told me I barely know French.
That sounds like a miserable world to live in. As always, stay loony, my friends.
Stay loony. Oh, man, look at all those patrons. Shit, I'm excited to start a Patreon that's just going to be, like, me donating to myself. I've thought about it, but I really don't want to start a Discord because, I don't want to deal with that shit. It's que pasa? My bad. My bad, Depreston. So we're gonna get into a bit of emo Ben, alright? This is Ben contemplating the end. This is the end of Ben Vangelion, okay? We're getting into the end of Ben Vangelion. So there he is. And I'm not doing anything here. He willingly posted a picture of himself. I don't know why he would do that, but there he is.
Hey guys, Ben Tannehill here. I'm sure you all saw the final review I posted concerning Ben T. Looney and Friends, and I just want to confirm that, yes, I'm retiring those characters for good. I'm sure this might upset a lot of you, but there's some...
Pendejo! Ah, fucking... You're a cabron. You're a cabron. Well, thanks for popping in, idiot. Appreciate it. Pendejo means a good friend.
Several reasons why it's time to put those characters to rest. Originally, I thought I was going to be able to keep going until the spring of 2014, but my college schedule is going to be chaotic next semester.
I'm
Yeah, I'm gonna be real. My man's looking like Chris Chan. he looks like post I Just Won Chris. Like, he really does look a lot like Chris, doesn't he? I love it. I love it. That's absolutely him, Barasan. That's his fucking big ass head. This nigga built like Frankenstein's monster.
I'm taking 6 classes, and I just wouldn't have the time to do all the editing that I do when it comes to the Ben T. Looney and Friends videos. Also, making videos was starting to become a chore for me, which is why I didn't make as much as I was making for the past couple of weeks, and why the finale got delayed. I just wasn't having as much fun making them as I did for the past 4 years. I didn't want to keep making videos if I didn't enjoy them, because I didn't want to risk them becoming weak and you guys getting angry.
Yeah, I'm just picturing fucking Chris Chan meeting his alter ego like it's Evil Ryu, and like the Sasui no Hado is showing up in him. He's like, just sees Ben the Looney with his eyes glowing red.
So I felt it was a good time to stop. Finally, from a creative standpoint, I was just running on empty. Usually, video ideas came to me with the snap of a finger, but recently, I was drawing blanks. Before I knew it, Sunday started coming around and I didn't know what to do.
Well, at least I wasn't shooting blanks.
Again, I didn't want to force videos out if I knew they weren't going to be entertaining, and I felt you guys weren't going to like them. So, that's
about it. Oh, I'm
worried,
Dale.
But, even though my characters are done doesn't mean I'm done. I still plan on sticking around to make retrospectives on my videos.
Yeah, this is Nate, sir.
I'm planning on making videos on my top 50 favorite movies, my favorite classic cartoons, and finally, my top 30 favorite animated TV shows. So, don't unsubscribe just yet. There's still a little bit of gas left in the tank, and I hope to keep you guys entertained until I have to move away to college. I'm Ben Tannehill. See you later.
Damn.
Because maybe...
Fucking Oasis jump scare at the end. Because maybe... So... Was that the end? No, he made a bit more content, and he went in that direction that we explored, where he talked about controversial topics. He's had a few different pivots, and we'll get into that as well. But we're going to jump into his modern version. So, if this was the end of Ben Vangelion, this one is the rebuild of Ben Vangelion. It even has the parentheses. It's called I Am Not Okay. This is Ben 3.33. I am not okay. Anyway, here's Wonderwall.
Not feeling so hot the past few months. As always, I apologize I don't make enough videos, but I have a very good reason for it. Well, this case is more bad than good. Here I was this morning, actually getting ideas for videos again. Planning some out. Thinking of what I want to do, then out of nowhere, depression anxiety comes and just smacks me across the face.
This is so Chris-esque. Like, when he really gets into the patterns of it, he just, like, gets right back into, like, Chris-style shit, for sure.
Remind me of the situation I'm in. I've been stuck working 48 hours a week for close to a year now at my real-life job.
My real-life job.
I had been doing perfectly decent for years before this. I was able to balance both my online activities and a full-time job. Sure, some weeks were worse than others.
Yeah,
but
modern Benny is worse.
I felt more in control of my situation. Now, not so much. I work so much that it's really been eating at my mental health for a while now. I still try to balance my passion for drawing with this hectic work schedule, but even that's not working out for me much anymore. I'm just too tired when I come home to even stare at my screen tablet. Then sometimes I try to start drawing.
I'm just too goddamn tired to make porn anymore.
Drawings in the morning before work. But that doesn't always work either, because things might come up that I gotta handle. Or I just can't get in a good drawing.
He's had two jobs. Didn't Chris have one job? Chris briefly worked at Wendy's, right? And I think Ben's worked at McDonald's, and he was also a janitor briefly. I think he was a college janitor.
mode, knowing that I had to get ready for work at a specific time. That added pressure makes it difficult for me to find a groove, so my art suffers for it, and then I beat myself up. Which is what I deserve, because, you know, I'm starting to question my life choices. Sure, I started out having dreams of making my own cartoons, but then, when I found out that wasn't...
Phasma, why are you egging on the feet talk?
I tried to make cartoons by myself, but of course, I can't write jokes and...
An Evangelion feet at that! Dear God!
...and draw to save my life. So, those ended up being disasters, too. I ain't directing that at my voice talent. They made those cartoons worthwhile. All this is directed at the work I did. I'm feeling...
My balls are so... My balls are so dry! My cooms aren't what they used to be. I used to shoot mad ropes, Megan.
I'm feeling so low that I'm killing my own work that I put my sweat and tears into.
Yeah, stop
so
me!
Cool. Guess I'll just draw. I can do comics. Oh, wait. Can't do that either. Gotta freaking work yourself to the bone just to make money and live. I freaking hate money. I hate it.
This man hates money. Like, that's just life, man. And, you know, you might have to time manage a bit, but, like, if you have hobbies, that's okay. Like, I, you know, I work full time and I do this stuff and I do a few other things and I do music because I make time for it and I, like, have a schedule. You know, he's just such a whiny bitch, man.
I absolutely freaking hate it. I hate the fact that I need it. I hate the fact that I have to sacrifice so much time and mental well-being just to earn it. But whatever. This is just the world I was brought into without my consent. Just one big turd sandwich we all gotta take a bite out of. All I wanted to do growing up was make something to entertain people. Make something to give people a break from anything that was bringing them down. But of course, nothing ever works out how I want it. I can work my ass off, kiss everybody else's asses, get my ass stepped on, but it all leads to, at the end of the day, is me being used to wipe other people's asses. How ironic, I'm working more than I ever have in my life, and it's in turn making me feel my lowest. Whoever's...
Yeah, this man is complaining about having a job, and it's probably not a particularly hard one. But he's like, I want to draw porn! I want to draw Puffy AmiYumi porn!
Said hard work leads to happiness can put a sweaty sock in it for all I'm concerned. Even if I was determined to make videos, it would just be nothing but misery for me. If I'm working on a video, I'm depressed because I ain't drawing. If I am drawing, I'm depressed because I can't come up with any ideas and my storytelling skills make little golden books seem like Shakespeare by comparison. This is just where I'm at now. Is this adulthood? Is this just what happens to people as they get older? Lose all their passion?
Well, great. He went to art school, and I think he wanted to be an animator, but he's not a particularly skilled animator, illustrator, anything, right? And he's also not willing to receive any criticism for people who are better than him at this stuff or have insight. So, like, he's pigeonholed himself into, like, he's not willing to grow as an artist, and he's not willing to get a 9-to-5 and just have a day job and do art on the side. He wants one or the other. Yeah, this guy's bitching about having 40 hours a week. For real. For fucking real. Like, he should be grateful that he's not working split shifts, or he's not working overnights, or he's not working 12 hours. He's not working some fucking grueling job. This guy just has a fucking, like, he has a mop in his hands, and he shows up, and then he leaves. That's pretty goddamn cushy.
Passion for what they love, and just give up on everything? Sure feels that way. Sometimes when I'm driving home, it's hard. Really hard. To not listen to that little voice in my head telling me to drive into a tree or a telephone pole or any...
This... What? This guy is having, like, suicidal ideations over working a 9-to-5. And he has a car. He has, like, you know...
this guy's like taking stuff so for granted. Like completely for granted. Christ almighty, man.
Anything just to take me out of my misery. Yes, folks, I battle with suicidal thoughts because of all this crap I deal with. The only thing that stops me is I think of my friends and loved ones. I think about how they would react if they found out I did something stupid like that, and it breaks me. I don't have it in me to take myself from them.
Well, I'm sure if something like that happened, your parents would be beside themselves, Ben. Or they might not be and go, hey, break out the champagne flutes.
But I'd be lying if I said I didn't sometimes find the pain is too tempting to quarrel. And you know, I wouldn't be so determined to keep making YouTube videos if it wasn't for the fact I don't want Ben Rants to be my legacy. I'm glad all of you out there got entertainment out of it. For me, it's nothing but pain and hurtful memories. So many hours I wasted looking for things to get angry about. So many times I didn't give things a fair chance. So many times so many people I pissed off.
Victor, I'm just saying. I'm not saying that it's a good thing or a bad thing, but I'm saying that some people may interpret something like that a certain way. You know, I don't know how his parents feel about him, but he's a pretty horrible, pathetic, weird man. He's a pervert. He is into CP. He defends weird CP. He's got like cum brain. And, you know, ultimately, like, I don't think that he can keep living the way he lives. This is the kind of guy who needs to just course correct. You know, he needs to find some positivity in his life and figure it out. It's unreal, you know? It's like, when you're thinking that way and you're thinking about doing something like driving into a barrier or a tree, that's pretty goddamn awful. It's like, dog, just like, I don't know, get some help, figure it out, find out what's good for you. Maybe find some passions in your life that aren't drawing puffy AmiYumi porn, man. Ah!
So much time I spent yelling and getting mad just for views and attention. I hate it. I hate thinking about it.
Thank you for joining, Seal.
That's it.
Work
beckons.
That's
all I'll ever be known for. No matter how hard I try, no matter how much I want to move on and do something I can be proud of, I'm constantly reminded that this is what I'm most known for. There are people out there who think that's who I am, that I'm not a real person behind all that rage and negativity. And that's nobody's fault but mine.
I'm a funny guy.
I didn't know any better. I was just a stupid kid doing things out of boredom because I grew up in the middle of freaking nowhere with no friends to hang out with. I can't live like this anymore. I just want to create and be myself.
Okay, so like, you know, and I'm not trying to be like an armchair therapist here or something, but his complaints are very surface level. And he also seems to not want to put in any effort to fix his issues. I grew up in buttfuck nowhere, so I did what I could do to have fun. Okay, cool. You know, and you did have fun. You made some videos. Maybe you're disappointed in them, or they're not indicative of what you want to do in your life moving forward. But they don't define you. That shit does not define you. If you want to create art, then you should be content with the art you're creating right now. The fact that you're drawing and you're consistently drawing. You know, there are plenty of people who are so busy, they don't get to play music. They don't get to draw.
They don't get to paint. They don't get to be creative anymore, despite having a yearning for it. I have a very good friend who works like overtime all the time. He's got a huge collection of guitars he doesn't even get to use. And he's always talking about wanting to record, but he doesn't have that opportunity to record anymore. Because of responsibilities. Because he has to pay his mortgage. Because he has people to provide for. Because he has needs. Because he has to pay his insurance. That's just what fucking happens when you're an adult. You have the luxury to even have time to think about managing. So manage it. Because dog, I'm gonna be real. You sound like a complete pussy. If you want to make art, you will find a way. You know, like, I know my audience personally isn't super into the hip-hop stuff I do, but I've made great inroads in that genre, and it's because minute one after getting home from work, I started working on it. All the time, every single day. Many times I would work on that stuff before I went to work. Because I love it. You know, I love it. It means a lot to me. I want to keep doing it. And even when I get to a point where I might want to pivot from producing, I might want to get into management. Because I love it. This guy sounds like a bitch. He sounds like a complete fucking bitch in that he's making a myriad of excuses and he's so incapable of even thinking about solutions. This nigga a pussy.
I want to make people happy with my work, but it don't matter. Even if I did make videos about stuff I love, my opinions don't mean shit. I'm boring, bland, and have the vocabulary of a brain-damaged redneck. I don't care about what I had to say on things. What could I possibly add? There's plenty of other YouTubers out there who can do much better than I can ever hope to. So what do you even need to hear my opinions for? I'm sorry. I'm sorry to let you all down. I'm sorry to be such a disappointment to my friends, family, and loved ones. I thought I was stronger than this. Thought if I kept my head above water and pushed forward with determination, I would be happy and accomplish what I want.
No, sometimes it doesn't work out like that, right? So you need to regroup, reassess, take a step back, figure out what is necessary for you to move forward and feel actualized. Yeah, absolutely, Star. It is main character syndrome. Because this guy isn't content having, you know, some semblance of online presence and making some art. You know, again, like, I don't mean to drudge it up, but this guy got to, like, talk with and hang out with Pan Pizza, who many people would love that opportunity. Many people would jump at that opportunity, right? Like, who are into cartoons or in that cartoon fandom. They would be very excited to do what he's done. But he's such a fucking ingrate that he can't even see how positive his life has been up to this point as a creator. And he's not even a good creator. When you start thinking about other people, you're going to inhibit your own creativity. When you start thinking about, like, oh, this guy's doing this, who fucking cares? They're not even on your goddamn radar. Turn it off. Do your own shit. If I was preoccupied with other YouTubers, I wouldn't be here. You know, I don't fucking care who has to, like, censor their swears, sell their soul, use stock footage, and fucking make the most sanitized content possible to hit the highest metrics so they can monetize that shit. Man, fuck that cornball shit. Just get a 9-to-5 and do this as a hobby. It's fun. This nigga a dork. This nigga straight corny. You know, like, I really hope that this guy, I don't have faith in him. I don't think he's capable of doing anything good with his life. But there are plenty of people in the chat who I know can do good. So if you ever feel like this fucking dork loser, please step back and reassess things and recognize that you might just have to reflect. This guy is cooked.
Well, I've been wrong plenty of times in the past. What's one more time? I don't know what's going to happen from here. For the first time in my life, I just don't care what happens. If this is my fate, so be it. What's the point to keep trying if all I ever get in return is pain and misery? Well, if I'm going to be everyone else's whipping boy, I might as well learn to adapt to it.
God damn! Well, guess I'll die. Guess I will die. Oh, man. Yeah, and he's had like 2 months between videos and then like 6 months between this Cat Icarus parody and this rant. It's like, you're clearly not putting in the time to make this channel succeed. You know? And it makes me sad he likes Dirty Pair, but whatever. So we'll take a look at a couple of his cartoons before we proceed.
Here we are, honey. Time for a stroll in the park.
Oh boy. Pollution-filled air and cancer-giving sunlight.
I knew you'd be excited.
Jerome, you parked it right.
I thought so. Why?
Yeah, that was Cat Icarus's face. We saw his face earlier. He's a dead ringer for Chris Chan. It's kind of embarrassing.
What do you know? Out of gas.
You talk too much.
And you snore.
Oh, would you shut the... Alright.
Yeah, I don't know, man. I think you're done. Jerome!
No one's home.
Okay, I'll just come back.
Hey, it's our boy Mr. Enter.
Wait a minute.
Yes?
Your rent is due.
No, I paid last month.
That was last month's rent.
I paid in advance.
Oh. In that case, have a good day, ma'am. What a nice, young, respectable... Alright.
Ooh. So yeah, like again, if this is the tier of shit he's making, it's not meant to be. Alright?
Alright.
Okay, we got more rant fiction. Alright. Alright, cartoons. Alright is generous.
More beating around the bush. I'm doing this video. I'm getting all this information out. I'm not hiding from myself anymore.
Why does this guy sound like he's about to find his persona? I'm just expecting... I'm not hiding from myself anymore.
Sorry if this video is a little heavy for some people, and it's not probably going to be the prettiest, but I think I need to let out some emotions.
Bottom text says he drew loose from the owl house. Come on, she's 12.
And inner anxieties, and just get them out in the open so people can help me deal with them and tell me everything's going to be okay. And other people who have the same
bottom text, don't spam it or anything.
Can take a look at me and know that they're not alone. Yeah, deep down, outside of the nice, zany, wacky guy who makes funny cartoons and very horny lewds, I do have some inner demons and anxieties that bother me from time to time, and a lot of them do come down from the core. Basically, I guess you can say one of my main issues I have is I do put the needs of others above my own.
Oh, come on, man. Like, come on. All right, Jim, that's very fair. So radio silence between vids isn't always bad, as long as the vids are worthwhile. Running Shine is like that. That's why it's one of my favorite YouTube channels. So that's a very fair point. So if the content is like high production, or there's a great deal of research, or the personality is captivating, those are a lot of reasons why he would have those radio silences. But he went from constant content to multiple months between content releases. Like, it just doesn't check out. It just doesn't check out. So, but I mean, yeah, he's just going to keep on licking his wounds. So we're going to look at some of his other monstrosities. So he briefly was a story time animator, kind of in the same vein as like Odd Ones Out or like Jaden Animations, and he wasn't a very good one. So let's check out some of his stories. I did a bit of research. I went to various sources. We definitely have to get to his artist spotlight. So I'll pull up a artist spotlight, and we gotta make sure that we get one of his McDonald's stories.
Hey folks, Ben the Looney here.
So it's like so completely derivative, just the way he draws his character in these.
So in my last video, I said that I'd talk about my work experience at McDonald's soon. Well, it's soon. I'll start off by saying that working at Mickey D's was a pretty positive experience. My managers were really nice, I got a lot of good hours, I got paid well, and being there myself, everything you heard about McDonald's on the news isn't true.
This is like one of the few fucking mud-brained people who would say that their experience at Mickey D's was positive.
Except for the food being bad for you, because let's not kid ourselves. It's bad for you. But overall, I had fun working there for a little over a year, and the customers were pretty awesome for the most part. But like any fast food job, you run into those customers who you swear are just trying to make you jump over the counter and beat the crap out of them. Let's talk about some, shall we? Some of my least favorite customers to deal with were the ones who would look for...
This really is great value on one's own.
Any reason to get a discount. Yeah, I was in here 2 weeks ago, and there was a hair in my food. Can I have a free meal? Do you have a receipt from this incident? No. Did you talk to a manager when it happened? No. Do you have any proof you were in here 2 weeks ago? No. I still get a free meal, right? And there was one lady who said she saw customers getting...
Oh, man, it's just the plagiarism is, like, so ridiculous. It's clearly him trying to put on, like, a typical story time animator style, but it doesn't fit the way he draws.
Getting a free sandwich. I explained that if you keep your receipt and fill out an online survey, you can bring it back and get a free sandwich that way. She then blankly stared at me and asked, "Well, can't you give me a free sandwich without the survey just this once?" Yes. I'm just gonna give you free food simply because you asked for it. That's not something I can get fired for. The last incident in this category I'll talk about is a lady ordered 17 sundaes.
I didn't even process the
free food
feet.
Simply because you asked.
The feet. Damn, the feet though. My girl wearing the size 15s, goddamn.
Talk about is a lady ordered 17 sundaes. Yeah, 17 sundaes in the drive-thru. McDonald's has parking spaces for drive-thru customers with big orders so they can wait for their food without holding up the line. So anyway, we're in the store making her 17 sundaes, then she comes in after being parked.
That's a very fair comparison, Corey, that like, the Randy Stair comparison kind of makes sense, because Randy Stair, much like Ben the Looney here, basically did like everything they could until it stuck. Like, they just tried every single type of content. And whatever worked, worked, and whatever didn't, didn't. But, like, it's just shameless how he's like, so willing to just rip off someone else like this. It's fucking wild. Aw, that's a reasonable size for a woman, Esmeralda.
For only a minute and says, yeah, you parked me, so now you're supposed to give me a free meal.
My nigga, what's with this guy's hair?
Because I have to wait so long.
Lady, you ordered 17 sundaes. We only have one ice cream dispenser. Go out there and wait for him.
Is what I wanted to say, but my manager actually caved in and gave her a free meal. I loved my managers, but some of them were too nice. Sometimes it was hard to predict how customers were going to act. And by sometimes, I mean all the time. Whenever I took drive-thru orders and I tried to give people their receipt, they'd give me the death stare. I wasted so much paper throwing away receipts.
Damn. Tragic. Tragic receipt tossing.
However, one day we ran out of receipt paper, and believe it or not, people were actually getting angry because of that. One lady even had the gall to ask, how do you run out of receipt paper? Because tree-killing customers make me throw them away. If it's one thing worse than the discount-seeking customers, it was the angry customers. The kind who were in a bad mood and just wanted to bring everybody else down. One lady was behind a woman who was trying to decide what to order.
Yeah, and the worst fucking part is that this video got almost 1 million views. The worst part is that YouTube is such a shit fucking platform that this dog shit video with its awful illustrations and its bad recording and its fucking, like, no comedic timing whatsoever got 741k views. I'm... God damn, man. I'm a hater. I'm hating. I'm on that hate.
And she was like, are you going to order today or tomorrow? She didn't stop there.
I'm 100% serious. Look at the numbers right there. Let me move this over. I think I have it cropped out. Boom. 741k. Story time shouldn't be popular. The algorithm should not dictate content. It's like, there was a time when YouTube was just a means for being creative. But whatever. What fuck it ever. Yeah, 741k views, 13k upvotes. I don't know my metrics because I don't take this shit very seriously. But, still makes me mad though.
When she got up to order, she had a buy one, get one free Big Mac coupon. A coworker took her order and handed her her receipt, and she started freaking...
brain story time when? Aw, oh, man, you wouldn't want to hear my stories.
Freaking out. You didn't credit my coupon! You didn't credit my coupon! My manager took a look at the receipt and pointed out to her that my coworker did, indeed, credit her coupon. She then said, the Big Mac is $4? I'm not coming in here anymore. Aw, but you're such good company in our store. One time I was taking an order for this one guy. Yeah, I want a plain hot spicy McChicken with nothing on it. Remember,
for real, I don't know why anyone would be a professional YouTuber. Because, like, everything fluctuates so constantly. Why wouldn't you just get a job? And the bulk of the people who I've talked to who are relatively successful on YouTube make less than me. So it's like, you know, unless you have a job in conjunction with your YouTube, you're probably not, like, making a boatload of cash. Obviously, you know, you got the million plus accounts who are doing quite well. But it seems like a lot of people don't do well at YouTube, despite, you know, having videos that have, like, upwards of 1 million views.
It's plain, plain, nothing on it. All right, anything else?
Honestly, funny, I'd have him on. If he reached out, I'd have him on. I'd happily talk to Dogs Eating Dog 6. It'd be fucking funny. And I wouldn't make it a hot seat interview. I'd ask him real questions.
No. Alright, here's your receipt. You! Most of my coworkers were Mexican, and I loved them. They were really nice, they taught me some Spanish words, and treated me like I was family. So now, I'm very defensive of Mexican people, which made me all the more sick when I had to deal with the other type of customer.
His time at McDonald's made him appreciate Mexican people? Is that what he said?
Me some Spanish words. Workers were Mexican. No. Alright, here's your receipt. You. Most of my co-workers were Mexican.
Most of my co-workers were Mexican?
And I loved them.
And I loved them. I love them.
They were really nice. They taught me some Spanish words and treated me like I was family.
La familia. La familia. Oh, mijo. Mijo, you need to clean up the fryer, mijo.
So now, I'm very defensive of Mexican people, which made me all the more sick when I had to deal with the other type of customer, the racist kind. I remember one lady in the drive-thru.
Walk up to the counter.
You were so helpful, you actually speak English. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! And then one guy, at front counter, mind you, actually asked me out of the blue, how come you're the only white guy here?
Damn. Damn, this guy got to fucking serve a Mickey, fucking McDouble to David Duke? Damn.
What is this, the 50s? We also had the dumb customers. I remember one lady ordered a green apple smoothie. She then came back and asked for a refund. What was her reason? I don't like green apple.
Then why the hell did you order a green apple smoothie?
The pendejo gringo.
Hey, what kind of sauces do you guys have for your nuggets? Barbecue? Honey mustard, ranch, sweet and sour, habanero ranch, buffalo, and honey. Can you repeat all those?
Senior discount coffee, that's it.
77 cents, please.
77 cents? Oh, forget that!
The following is based on actual incident. The quotes are exaggerated for comedic effect.
Yeah, my son threw up all over one of your tables.
Are you going to be a responsible parent and clean it up yourself?
No, I'm going to ask you to do it because you're a fast food worker who doesn't get paid enough to put up with crap like that.
Damn, based dad, hell yeah! Based motherfucking dad. I'm going to get this idiot who works at McDonald's to clean up the vomit instead.
Here's a combination of both an angry and a dumb customer. I would like the crispy chicken sandwich meal, but instead of soda, I would like a milkshake. What size milkshake? What sizes do you have? Small, medium, large. I'll do medium. Alright, 977, please.
What the hell? Why is it so much?
The crispy chicken meal is our most expensive meal, and you want a milkshake instead of a soda, so there's a drink.
Clean it up, Wagey.
Drink up charge. It says that you get a medium drink with the meal. You get a medium soda with the meal. But if you want a different kind of drink, it's extra.
Yeah, but you're not taking away the price of the drink.
We take the price of the meal, and any drink that's not soda gets added into it only counts for the amount that is.
For real, I can't imagine working at McDonald's as an adult. Because all of these fucking nothing conversations, man, are killing me. Vic with $1 saying, I'm getting a Forrest Gump level of intelligence from Ben. I love Forrest Gump. But this is what I'm getting. Yeah, this is like if Forrest Gump wasn't a good person and was a coomer.
Is that included in the price of the meal?
You're charging me more!
No, we're not, sir.
How much is the meal if I get a drink? Then add my milkshake onto that.
I proceeded to literally write out the prices and do the math for him. Even when it didn't add up, he still freaked out. He forgot tax was a thing.
You're retarded!
Yeah. Yeah, you are. Yeah, it's like, I mean, you guys are not wrong. It's just like mind-blowing that he fucking aped Odd Ones Out so poorly, somehow got a modicum of success from it, and, you know, the resulting product is quite dog shit, but We got to look at an artist spotlight. He sure is. He sure is. So, again, he was briefly sponsored by Frederator. And he would use his artist spotlight series to talk about artists that he likes coombait from.
Hey, folks. Welcome back to Artist Spotlight, where I showcase the best artists the internet has to offer. Today, the spotlight is shining on another good friend of mine, and one of the nicest guys I've ever met. He is as smart about animation as he is sharp with the pen. He is the one and only SB99. Turns out that before we even met, SB...
What are these proportions? It's like chest, torso, hip. Jesus fucking Christ, what are these proportions? Use a guide, holy fuck.
He was a fan of my videos while I was following his art.
Yeah.
I guess I stumbled upon his art when I was searching through Hi-Hi Puppy AmiYumi fan art, and I found some of his old Ami and Yumi drawings.
Yep.
I was excited.
Yeah, Cow, it's all kids, Cow. It's all kids.
I didn't see somebody else remember that show other than me. I've been following his art ever since he's been drawing like this. But never you fear, folks. He's gotten a lot better. His characters are some of the smoothest and prettiest I've ever seen. He's got a simple but unique style that's very curvy and cartoony. He got into art simply because he loves cartoons and started drawing them. And I noticed that...
There is a serious problem with, like, cartoon fans and just going like, yo, what if this miner had cake, though? What if this miner had cake?
His style has evolved as he's gone along. I'm amazed by his ability to copy any style he can put his head to. Some people might say...
I wouldn't be surprised, Matthew.
...say that that shows a lack of identity on his part. But the way I see it, it shows that he's not a one-trick pony. He can draw in all these different styles and make them look accurate. If he ever gets hired to work on a cartoon, I can say that I wouldn't be surprised. But when SB isn't making art, he's an animator, and a dang good one at that. See so yourself on his YouTube channel, where he makes show-accurate animations and comes up with his...
Yeah, this ain't show-accurate, man. I mean, it's not really on model either, but it's just like a lot of, like, tween and puppet animation. Like, that's a pretty fucking low bar for show-accurate animation.
His own creative stories to put characters in. It's like animated fan fictions. It's also worth noting that one of his videos is viral. His video, The Puberty House, has over 2 million views and counting.
The Puberty House!
That's incredible. I don't know how he does it, but it brings a smile to my face knowing that a close friend of mine has such great success. His 2 million views feel like my 2 million views. Congrats, SB. You deserve it.
Good job, SB.
Honestly, this is a hard video for me to make, as SB...
It is a passable Flash animation. It absolutely is. But he called it a show-accurate animation, which it is not. Not even close.
SB is one of the most modest guys I know. If I had a video with 1 million views, I'd be excited as hell. But...
Why is he doing this to Madison? So gross.
SB just told me, yeah, I'm really lucky. There's an example of a guy who doesn't let fame go to his head. While he is popular, he doesn't use that as an excuse to put himself over anybody. If anything, he's probably his worst critic. He's harder on himself than anybody on the net could ever be.
Yeah, fangirl, Chris Savino is a interesting guy. I'm actually working on a video about him and a couple other folks. I'm doing one about him, John Kay, and Steve Reich from Rugrats. Because there are a lot of sickos in the cartoon industry, and I don't know why. I do not understand why they all have to be perverts, but they all are.
He's even encouraged me to critique him in this video. How many people do you know encourage critiques
about them? I get around, you know, random.
If there's anything I can say about your art, it's a little too niche. The Loud House fan art is nice.
Guys. I'm fucking. I am without words. I am without words. Isn't she like the second or third youngest one in that show? I stopped because I was baffled and upset.
And all, but it does get a little tiring seeing the same characters over and over again. You do draw a lot of stuff, as your portfolio is massive. I barely scratch the surface when it comes to showing all these people your art in this video. You're one of the most creative guys I know, as you make art for things that I won't even think about making art for. You're young, you're still in the growing stages, so I know you're only gonna get better. Heck, I'll go as far to say as I think you draw better than me, and I'm 3 years older than you.
Is Shima doing ass to ass? Is that what happened to her after Super Planet Dolan? She just went to the Requiem for a Dream ass to ass room?
I'll go as far to say.
Ass to ass!
Say as I think you draw better than me, and I'm 3 years older than you. So, I'd say try expanding your horizons a bit. Draw more characters from other cartoons you love, not just the Loud House. Also, girls standing and looking pretty is not bad, but seeing the same pose over and over again gets a little tiring.
Is this guy giving pose critique? We looked at his poses earlier. He does hand on the hip. That's his one pose. That's the pose he does every time. One hand on hip, one hand out. Every single fucking time. And he's giving pose critique to this person who's objectively, gross, but better than him. $4.99 from Depression. Make an edit with Ben and Epstein saying, "You kill the man, not the idea." Oh, man.
I tried drawing more complex poses, or drawing from different angles. I got some websites full of photo references that can help you if you want them. Don't get me wrong, I love your art. But you pushed me to give you some pointers, so I figured I'd fulfill your request. You've got a lot of potential, and I know you're only going to get better from here. So take what I say with a grain of salt. That being said, SB's art, while simple in nature, is so well drawn that it really doesn't matter to me much. I've said before that I prefer a more simple style of art, and not overly complex stuff. So SB's drawings really don't get my snooty elitist alarm flag.
See, Random, though, this guy literally went to art school. And he learned nothing from it. He probably had to do figure drawing. It was probably part of his course syllabus. And he learned absolutely nothing from his time at art school. Not even a little, not even a smidgen.
Flashing. He's acknowledged that his art isn't for everybody. And I'm sure he's had his fair share of critics who have put him down, mad at him for his success while feeling like there's so much better than him. Well, success happens by accident. And as the great Booker T once said, don't hate the player, hate the game. SB.
That wasn't even... Alright, whatever. Alright, okay.
He just wants to draw. It's not his fault a lot of people love what he does. Even he is surprised by his own success. Honestly, with how much people on the net have an ego, it's a breath of fresh air to see somebody, an artist mind you, who just considers himself a regular guy, who just likes to draw and make cartoons. He's not trying to be the next best thing. He's just being himself. In my opinion, that's all he needs to be. That being said, even I've taken notice of...
Damn, that bean-ass head she's got. Yo! Much like Booker T. I think Booker T once said, "We coming for you, nigga!"
His popularity and asked him on what his secret was. He simply...
She really do have the Stan Smith shit. <She's... laughs> My girl about to say good morning, USA.
He told me to draw whatever I want, and not to be afraid of what anybody
the
says.
The nigga chin!
That's some of the best advice anybody has ever given me. And not a day has gone by since I haven't thought about that. SB's art may not be the most complex out there, but I've seen how much he's improved, so I know he's only going to get better from here. Things can only go up for this young up-and-comer. I'm happy to be a fan, and I'm even happier to be a friend. Keep up the good work, SB. So what do you guys think of SB99's art? If you don't know him, check out his work.
I think his art's disgusting, and I think you're disgusting. So, before we wrap up, because we might have a Ben part 2 down the line, because, boy, he's got a lot of stuff to look at. We're gonna take a look at his appearance on the Pan Pizza podcast. Okay, what we got here? What we got here? Damn, all the stars are here. Oh shit, this was back when Nolan was on. Oh man, these are bad years. $5 from the Rat King. Kill, 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 kill. Well, thank you very much, Rat King. Oh fuck. Oh, it's probably all low lights. I kind of hope people tagged it. I guess Nolan brought this on, but Nolan was the worst. This podcast sure was a mess, and they did a reboot that was also a mess, if I recall correctly.
Full tension was the beginning of this podcast. I feel
like... Yeah. All the stars are here, Evan. All the Pan Pizza's here, and Ben the Loony. I saw Ben the Loony. He was very disappointed he was here and not at a playground. He wasn't at a playground, Cassim.
Like, if he's willing to try, he will find something beautiful.
I just want to say, if anyone wants to skip
Nolan was also a creep, if I recall correctly. Maybe that was someone else. Because Jim was normal. Izzy just moved on to stuff. I believe Nolan was in some sort of grooming controversy. The receipts are out there.
Head from the shame. There's links in the description with time codes that'll tell you where to skip.
Well, yeah, Nolan brought on bad guests, but maybe if Pan, like, had a fucking backbone and could just tell people not to be idiots.
They would already hit the shame. Yeah. We're midway through.
I'm gonna edit this backwards. I'm gonna edit this and move it to the beginning.
Izzy, I hate to break.
It's like, and don't get it twisted, I love Pan. He's one of my favorite content creators, but man has never had a spine. I can criticize someone I like.
It gets you, but we're not halfway through. It's only been 10 minutes. Oh, shit!
Oh, my God. Fuck. We're in here for, like, another 50 minutes. Oh.
50 minutes. 70 minutes. All right. I guess since we're here for the interim, who's the hottest pony?
Hey.
All right. Ben is asking the real questions. Who is the hottest pony? Chat. If you can let me know who the hottest pony is, it's greatly appreciated.
Well,
oh boy, this might take me
okay,
a while.
Okay, well, if you were an opponent,
my thoughts are Spike the Dragon, because he's a virgin, therefore his asshole is probably very tight.
Oh. Yeah, look, I think
I would have to say
Punished
Fluttershy. Yeah, Fluttershy. Yeah, the shy ones are always the most kinky, you know?
Yeah.
God! that made me so sad I hit the fucking Kanye Black skinhead. God.
Fluttershy probably has, like, a BDSM dungeon.
Yeah.
You know, like a shed.mob by, like, that guy Hot Diggity Demon. I think he's, like, a racist or something. He, like Fluttershy has a dungeon, but instead of, like, you know...
Hot Diggity Demon is not a racist. He's just an idiot.
Fucking, like, murder dungeon. It's like a BDSM dungeon. And it's like, yeah, dude. Like, Fluttershy probably takes Rainbow Dash there and, like, you know, fucks her or whatever. It's probably really great.
Why is this happening?
Fluttershy? What were we talking about? More like Sluttershy.
Oh, God. Thundercats, really yo! Funny.
Hey there, everyone! My name's...
Yeah, I really like how, like, Pan just, like, refuses to, like, take the reins back from his show. He just, like, will not pull back any sort of semblance of control. He just lets things happen until they stop happening. Chaos reigns. Hell yeah, Antichrist reference. That's pretty cool, Cal.
What they're making, and then they get mad, and then people are feeling attacked, and then it's just like an Ouroboros. Y'all just need to, like, just turn off the computer.
go outside, start a noise band, eat hummus with them, start some kind of salsa company.
I'm sorry, Greg.
Go down to the street, go down to the local market, go to your Trader Joe's, buy some like flaxseed chips, get some organic salsa.
Maybe we should do a Nolan episode.
And eat that.
Yeah.
Oh man, fucking promo jump scare there.
We could all agree with that one,
yeah.
Ben.
Yeah, okay, yes. So I respect everybody who works on Thundercats Roar as like people, but because you guys didn't name it Thundercats Ho, I've lost that respect for you.
Well, they
so...
can't because of the Me Too movement.
It was me too. It was me too. Yeah. Okay. All right. Okay. Do a pizza party podcast episode. Oh, that would be very agonizing.
What's the Me Too movement?
You don't know what that is?
Isn't that like a band? Isn't that like the guy? Wait, aren't those the guys who did Spider-Man Turn Off the Dark?
No. No, it was the Me Too movement. It was the scene in the second Matrix where Agent Smith meets Agent Smith and he says, "You, yes, me. And then the other guy says, "Me too." And that's the Me Too movement. And everyone just like moves in on Neo and beats the shit out of him. And there's a long ass fight scene that goes on for 8 hours. And then it contributes nothing to the plot. And then a bunch of anime.
So, like, I'll say this much to each and every one of you, because we're coming to the very end of this program, this journey into madness. This is what cartoon people talk like all the time. This is just how they talk. They just pepper each other with like cynicism and references and weird like sexuality. And they don't know how to have a regular ass conversation with one another. You just have to communicate with the next dry jab or cartoon reference to fit in with these kind of people. It's not good. It's not good. You don't want to be around these kind of people. Pan Pizza makes a mad video, but yeah, I don't know how much fun he would be to talk to, if I can be quite candid.
A bunch of Newgrounds people who like reanimate that scene with Mario and Sonic and on Newgrounds.com with a five-year-old.
So okay, I say we get a petition.
It is the norm. If you've ever seen John Kay on Stern with Billy West, that's probably the Chad experience in the cartoon sphere. That's as close as you're going to get to two normal people. And one of those people was a horrible pedophile. So that should tell you what the average cartoon watcher's conversation is like. It's, yeah.
I fucking hated it, and now all these fucking memers are coming back to meme it up again. Like, no, thank you. Like, I saw that. Like if you didn't see that shit in...
Nah, depressed in Dumpsville yells about opium and Playboy Cardi a lot. That's usually what it's like hanging out with him. I'll hit his line for you, man.
Theaters, that's cultural appropriation. Fuck you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, topical. I hated it.
I actually like that movie.
Get out.
Let's see where Mike Myers is in. He's going to be in that Bohemian Rhapsody movie. Interesting.
Oh, yeah, the Queen biopic. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But hey, we got
other... It looks interesting, but I don't know if it's going to be any good.
We got other news, you know? Hey, so you guys remember the... You guys remember the Canadian show 16?
Like, the way that, you know, the way that, like, Pan jumps in every single time, it's so sheepish. You know, he just like, so, anyway, guys, like, just jump in. Just go, all right, moving right along. You know, like, just jump in. I'm not an expert, but it's mind-blowing. These guys had, like, hundreds of, like, 100-something episodes. And it was always this dynamic of people talking over the host of the goddamn show. I think it's there's like minor edits, Goose. But me and Doom would have to take a look at Smash together because he's the expert.
Yeah, I don't want to.
Anyone?
Why is it coming back?
Okay,
I'm allowed to say this because the legend is true. Our prayers have been answered. There is going to be a special 16 reunion episode. That's all I know. That's all they'll let me know about.
Well, they're making a reunion special, and it was announced by the voice of Jude, Christian Potenza, and the guy who created Chris.
Do you want to take another crack at that name?
I don't know who these are.
Oh, goddamn. Okay, so Umsley A. Ermington says that Nolan was accused of commissioning minors' fetish art. So he was commissioning fetish art from minor artists. And yes, that was Jude. And the guy from Total Drama Island, the main host. Smasher Pass a Grapefruit. Oh, I'm a... that's a tough one. That's a tough one. I'm a pass, but I don't know. Depends. Depends on how lonely I am. Yeah, these, like, obviously these niggas are so dry and horrible. Let's get to the meat and potatoes here. But yeah, Nolan's a creep. Nolan's a fucking creep.
Or not, so I think I did my job well.
Sure.
I do too, but everyone knew the podcast was trash.
Whatever.
Like, am I serious? Am I not? Did I really see that one kid being held?
This podcast makes, like, fucking very late look like Joe Rogan.
Down and poured ranch on in middle school? We may never know. No one knows.
I hate this fucking show. Just end it. Mm-hmm. Are you fucking proud of yourself?
Like, look, I made videos just on the account of, like, yeah, why is no one talking about the 2000s era?
Good for you. Yeah. I'm so proud of you. Like, yeah. You did what nobody else did and made videos about shit nobody cares about. Good job.
Imagine if your fucking friend spoke to you that way. Like, for real. Imagine if your fucking friend, like, just basically said, you're retarded. I hate you. I hate you so much. You're so fucking dumb. And the content you make is for dumb people. And you're a waste of fucking space. And even though you gave me an opportunity, I don't even want it. I don't even want to be on your stupid show, you dumb idiot. Why is Ben on the podcast? I don't know.
I'm curious, Pam. When did you start making videos?
Actual review-based videos, like 2010.
I still remember one of your first videos that you uploaded was the Superman 64, where you were just beating a problem, and you were like, y'all are a bunch of fucking pussies, you suck, fuck you.
Kazma, you guys aren't my friends. I'm joking. I actually interact with you guys a lot, and I like all the people who come here. And there are so many recorded, pieces of evidence of me going, I have the best fans ever, and I really appreciate you guys, and I can't believe we got to this milestone. I've said it so often. What else do you want from me? What else do you want from me? I love you guys. I'm very happy that you show up and participate in me watching weird crap. I like it a ton. You know, and I talk to you a lot, Cass. I can't be friendlier.
Look, I was a fucking pro at that game. Like, if that's an esports, I'm ready, you know?
Do you really want to be known as the top Superman 64 esports player?
Hell yeah. Like, imagine just, like, everyone in...
Who's my favorite fan? Don't make me choose... DePreston. And I'm sure once he gets a word of me saying that, he'll refute that he's a fan. Yeah, DePreston notes. It's DePreston.
in a fucking stadium.
It's always been DePreston. Events,
like, they'd be throwing hula hoops at me and saying, like, Pan, fly through those rings. And I'd be like, what up?
And you try dive bombing into them, but you fall over and, like, spaghetti, like, explodes out of your pocket. And you're like,
don't look at me.
Yeah, just the way you said that, just the way, like, go Pan, fly through these hoops, like, it was the meekest, like, almost pathetic, but it was adorable.
when we all meet up at Momobukan, I want to take a picture where Pan is just in the fetal position.
You're not wrong, Kaz.
They're just looking down at him. Like,
you know, my ex was Italian. Have I ever streamed myself making music? I have. Those don't do particularly well because it's not me laughing at a idiot. But I love showing my process, and I have a lot of fun with it. I usually take requests. At some point, I might do a few other beat streams. But yeah, I have a few past VODs.
Completely expressionless, just like no judgment, no laughter, just complete resignation. Like, yeah. We've done this 100 times. We know what happened.
Superman 64 was the N64's answer to Nights into Dreams. Fact.
Hey, kill yourself.
You know they're the same game.
Please just end your life.
Nah, we got a lot to go through until it ends, you know.
Unfortunately, you're fine. Yeah. So.
But we got other news.
Like, again, this nigga's supposed to be his friend. Like, all right, so we don't have a ton of Ben. I mean, I'm sure if we really hop through here, we get some moments of Ben. Another King Asriper type beat stream. Happily. I'd love to go through a bunch of farting and groans and make a trap beat out of that. Yeah, if like obviously if you go through this, there are moments where Ben shines. But so much of this dog shit podcast was just Nolan being mean to Pan. Izzy occasionally has a freak out and she gets mad and calls them assholes. And then Pan, like, meekly cries and gets upset. Yeah, Rebel Taxi. That's how we were closing out Doom, is the guy we were covering, Ben the Looney, was on Pan Pizza's podcast at one point. And it was about as terrible as you can ask for.
He could have meet the Feebles. Sign me up.
Yeah.
That's all the news we have.
Thank Christ, Pan.
You guys want to get into the questions?
All right, guys, you can start asking your questions now.
Yeah, so if anyone at one...
Yeah, Ben just sitting in the corner while this fat, hairy man goes, Pan, you should kill yourself. You should kill yourself, Pan. Doom, someone asked me to look at Smash Bandicoot, so if you want to help me through that would be a lot of fun.
Once asked a question, be sure to post a comment with the word question so it's easier to find. And our first question is from Retrozoid says, what other people would you like to meet at MomoCon? Well, we're not going to meet Doug Walker, that's for sure. That's not happening.
Yeah.
We were gone through the whole freaking Channel Awesome controversy.
Damn. Yeah. Yeah, you see, like, I had a plan. Okay, since he's not coming, I can tell everybody what my plan was.
Oh shit, hello B, and I hope you're doing very well. Hi B. This is agonizing. Okay, let me ask you guys, all right? No, I'm not gonna watch Pan's trailer for Loki. You guys make it very hard for me to firmly say I like Pan Pizza's content and I don't want to mock him, but god damn it, the VOD is crazy B. It's very nuts. If I was to get my own Pizza Party podcast panel, alright, if I was to do a 4P of some of our strongest soldiers who have no chemistry, much like the Pan Pizza podcast, so it'd probably be myself and three people who hate each other. Would you guys want us to do a fucking drinking stream watching the Pizza Party podcast's lowlight? Let me set up a poll. I think I'm going to set up a poll and just make it a yes or a no, all right? Pan Pizza stream next. All right. Pizza Party podcast panel stream with guests and booze. All right. And that's just a yes or no. I want to see if you guys would be interested. And well, I'll keep that running for a bit. I'll keep it running for a minute.
What I was going to do is I was going to act like a fan who like was about meeting him for the first time. And I would have worn like a hoodie or something, like a zip up one. And I would have been like, oh my God, you're Doug Walker. Oh my God.
Cause like this shit would be so painful to watch with a group of people and to like try and enjoy it. You know, the flip side is that I would probably tank any chance I have of ever talking to Pan Pizza, but I've probably already tanked that chance by even doing this. So, and truth be told, we probably have nothing in common. I know that Suki's gonna hit me up and go like, "Dog, you fucked up, man. You fumbling the bag, man. You fumbling the." Yes, Seal, he did. He did.
I'm such a huge fan. Can I have a picture with you? And he would have been like, yeah, sure. And I would have had my friend like come in and take he was taking the picture. I would have unzipped my hoodie and it would have said, change the channel.
All right. It's a very staggering 100% yes. He might respect. Why do I want his respect? He's a cartoonist. For real. Not to gas myself up, but I've, like, worked with, like people who have been nominated for Grammys. Why do I need an indie cartoonist to respect me? We hella blackballed? Nah, we so blackballed, we looping right back to white balls, man.
On it. So when Doug Walker was smiling, like, and
talking
with me, I would be wearing a shirt that said, change the channel, and I would have posted on Twitter saying, Doug Walker approved.
I was kind of expecting white balls. Like a Pickle Ree, like that McDonald's guy, the one that was screaming on the counter.
No, I'm embarrassing, but I'm not pathetic.
Okay. You know, apparently that guy was a parody, like it wasn't real.
Yeah. A Skull Monkey. I don't even like goth boys, but you know, I'm sure I could put on a front. And yeah, I'm sure he gets that a lot of random people going, goth girls, yeah, Raven.
It don't matter.
Yeah, that's what they all say.
Yeah.
But like, there's a long extended video of him just doing stuff.
Yeah, just like my video where I'm crying over a girl. Yeah, that's just a parody.
Cam,
yeah.
We know those are real stuff.
Yeah. All right, so it's happening. It's happening, but like it would be the kind of thing where we'd have to get fucking decimated. I'd say it would be like take a shot anytime you cringe, which would be a lot. And we would find some of the best worst episodes of this program. Like it would have to be some of the Super Brand Kingdom's strongest soldiers, undoubtedly. Goth boys can be hot sometimes. You're not wrong. You're not wrong. But I won't succumb to their charms. And on that zero chemistry weird note, and that promise of things to come, I think that's what we're going to wrap up, because I'm kind of cresting the 3-hour mark. Thank you so much for being a part of this. I always appreciate each and every one of you being there. So all of them. fuck. Is Everclear too strong for shots? Yes. Yes, it is, Star. Yeah, you wouldn't be a regular drinker if you took shots of Everclear. You'd be some sort of superhuman drinker. But yeah, thank you for joining me as we ranted on this user. Hoping to connect with the homie Club Doom next week. We're going to be finally taking a collaboration look at the Super Origami Kingdom together. We're going to be looking at the Omni King Saga. And once we wrap that up, I'm going to be editing a big compilation of all of the Super Origami Kingdom stuff. So it's time. It's time. We've fussed around enough. We've introduced you guys to the Super Origami Kingdom plenty. You know the lore, you know the characters, the players. It's time for the Omni Kings next week. This user is the Opinion Basher. Let's fucking go. So, of course, y'all, thank you so much for being here. And big peace. Y'all have a wonderful night. Goodbye. Don't support Ben the Loony. Make sure he feels bad about everything. Don't